Okay, that's
I don't even know the beat.
yeah, that
You know, I heard it a million times.
Urbans. That's listen. That's the theme we're gonna go with because I'm not doing any sound shit.
Why are you good with memorizing, like knowing how to do a like a song or whatever in your head? Because like even if I hear something a lot of times, I can't do it. I mean, that's why I'm not a musician, you know.
What do you mean, like playing it by ear?
Yeah.
If I
just like knowing how to do the beat with like your mouth or something, you know.
Yeah, I'll be driving along and like I'll be like, I call it humming because I don't have a fucking word for the noise, the percussive noise I'm making with my mouth, but it's because my wife hates whistling, and I get it because I'm around whistlers and I hate hearing them, so I can imagine how bad I sound. So instead, I'm always doom, 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 boom, boom. Yeah.
Of course, women hate whistling because they get whistled at all the time.
Yeah, well, so yeah, I'll be in the car, but the, you know, doing a little bass line to something I remember, and then like, you know, throwing the drums, you know, just see how far I can go with it before it just falls to shit.
Yeah.
So how are you, Mr. Ian?
I'm pretty good. Pretty good. Pretty good. I'm alive and kicking. I keep on kicking, chicken wang.
Chicken wang.
Chicken wang. Never get that fucking right.
When's the last time you saw Joe Dirt?
When did it come out?
Are you serious?
It's been a long time.
It's one of those movies, if like I'm flipping through the channels and that's on, I'll go, yeah, I'll watch this.
Yeah.
I was thinking about it, like there's a subreddit called Shower Thoughts where it's like when you're washing yourself and your mind just fucking wanders and you think shit you would never think normally. I had like a shower thought, I'm washing myself, I'm like, okay, so if I'm watching TV, what's the shows that like I'm flipping through the channels and I'll stop and see what episode it is, even though I've seen every fucking episode that exists. I want to see what episode is on right now. I have them all and can watch them. But I want to know what one's on right now for some reason.
Right.
So, like, Golden Girls. Gilmore Girls.
Golden Shower Girls, what?
Yeah, that's what I said.
That's what I heard.
And The Nanny. You probably don't remember The Nanny, do you?
It vaguely sounds familiar.
With Fran Drescher?
Oh, yeah.
Hilarious. The Nanny. Yeah. I know it's all gay stuff, but whatever. You can think what you want.
Gives a shit.
Yeah. Men in their 30s, they either are really offended by someone else thinking they might be gay, or they just don't give a fuck. I'm the don't give a fuck type.
I heard somebody was talking about that. Do you ever watch that show, Black Mirror?
Yes. No. No. No.
I guess it's a pretty popular show.
Yeah.
It's like a lot of theoretical shit on there or something, you know, like scenarios.
You ever watch it?
I watched like a couple episodes. It's a weird show.
Hmm.
I guess each episode has like its own like scenario or whatever. So you could watch the show, like it doesn't have to be in order, you know?
Yeah, it's an anthology series.
Yeah,
kind of like Twilight Zone.
Right.
Like you just pick up each one without having to see it. It's a standalone, basically.
Right, right. But no, I guess they brought up on one episode, they brought up a scenario of like if two guys are like straight or whatever, but they go into virtual reality and one of them does like they have like a female NPC like you do on Fallout or whatever, or character or whatever you call it, and
your avatar or whatever, yeah.
Yeah, Avatar, and then, and then they do it. You know, I mean, is that gay?
Yeah.
I would say, I guess it depends on what you're getting out of it. If you're just doing it for shits and giggles, I
I
think it would
mean,
be less so, but.
well, it's like those people that catfish other people, and it's like, oh, fucking fag believed that I was a girl the whole time. It's like, yeah, but you had in-depth discussions with some guy pretending to be a girl. Oh no, did we lose Ian?
Hello?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Where's
Oh,
your.
sorry. I had to check a text message. I guess the camera went out then or something, huh?
Yeah. You're looking at porn, don't lie.
I got a tablet. I got a bigger screen, man.
Anyway.
So, while I text here, what has Frank been up to?
Well, just today, after work, I came home and mowed the lawn because the media got me all on a fucking word. It's going to be nice and sunny Friday and then shitty afterward. And it rained every day since last Saturday. So I was like, okay, I'm not going to stand at the fucking door all day Saturday and hope for a glimmer of, like, oh, there's some sun. I can get out there and mow. I'm just going to mow it while I know it's nice and not have to worry about the shit on Saturday, you know? And I get there and I text my wife. I'm like, hey, I'm going to go ahead and mow when I get home. I get home and I put the dogs in their crate and I get the gear on to mow and I get the mower out and I'm literally about ready to pull the thing and she texts me, well, it's not supposed to rain tomorrow now, so apparently if you don't want to do it, I'm like, I'm fucking already here, just knock it the hell out.
Right.
So I mowed, I took a shower, shaved,
She
and
shower and shave.
something like that, and then three S's as my buddy calls them.
Yeah.
And what else did I went to Little Caesars and got a pizza because I was like, yeah, it's normally Taco Bell night, but I spent a lot of fucking money at Taco Bell and I haven't been really happy every time I go, so I'll just get a
Happy.
yes, yeah, so I'll just get a fucking pizza and breadsticks and a fucking 2 liter.
Little sleezers.
Yeah. Hey, what do Hispanics used to cut their pizza with?
What?
Little Caesars.
Even Frank's got some jokes once in a while.
My ex, who was Mexican, actually thought that was fucking hilarious. Anyway, so that's pretty much it. I mean, I've been working overtime, like, pretty much every day this week. I come in early. I don't stay late because my wife stays late, so I have to come home and take care of the dogs some nights. I haven't really had, I come home and eat and go to sleep. Pretty
So
boring
I'm gonna
shift.
need you to come in on Caturday.
I need you to go ahead and come in on Caturday, yeah.
That's what Ben says.
So, well, you've seen the meme with the cat with the tie.
Oh yeah, that's right.
That's adorable. So, what is Ian drinking on? Soda Talk with Frank and Ian.
Are we doing what has Ian been up to, or what have I
We
been
started with
drinking on?
that.
You asked me how I've been. Keep on keeping on.
Okay. Sorry, I get confused.
You try to give me.
I get confused easy. Oh wait, no one cares. You've been watching Dogs.
Well, I've been watching Dogs, but also I wanted to say I decided I'm gonna try doing some vlogs on the channel. I uploaded a vlog last night just doing kind of like a house tour here. I want to do a apartment tour sometime when I get back. I recorded some videos and stuff already today that I'm gonna cut together and do kind of like what I've been up to for the weekend also for a second vlog. But I wanted to put some other stuff on the channel where it be, like that shorter besides just like 4 hour long podcasts, you know?
Yeah, I was thinking about that today because I had a little bit of downtime at work and I was like, well, Or like I was doing, you know, mind numbing shit where I'm filing paperwork, so I want to have something on the background. And like I go to a YouTube channel and the vlogs are actually interesting now that you mention it. Like there's the guy who's like building shelves for his fucking garage, and I don't give a shit, but I'll put that on for a half hour while he fumbles around and does that. But when I go to a channel and it's just all like podcasts of him and his buddy sitting around talking about shit, I don't watch any of it.
Yeah. But I mean, if you do like the, if you do give a shit about like us or whoever's doing a podcast in general, then you would, you might like a shorter blog here and there, you know?
Yeah, just, you know,
Sprinkle it in there.
spoonful of sugar.
I like to do, start doing some tutorials and stuff like Ben does, but that's like a lot of production, you know?
Well, I mean, as long as you're somewhere between a lot of production and those, like, you know, 8-year-old kids who, like, use a trial version of screen recorder and, like, here's how you crack this software and it'll do that. Don't pay attention to that. And oh, hold on,
Yeah.
I got a license here. Let me type in the code. What do you mean it's not working? They could edit that out, but they fucking are too dumb to know how.
Yeah, don't pay attention to my cracking voice.
Right, and like the middle of the screen says recorded with Bandicam.
Right.
And like then they got music over top of it, or they do produce it, but they got music over top, and they're talking, and you can't fucking hear a word they're saying. Because the music's
Yeah.
going like 900 beats a second. And every comment is like, dude, turn the fucking music down. I appreciate it, but I can't understand.
Yeah.
Or, my favorite is the title's in English. Why isn't the video?
Yeah. Plus, you were saying that your other viewers or whatever that said that they wanted
More
more of
Ian.
me or whatever, more Ian, they might be able to at least get straight to that, to seeing me, and maybe I'll do some like talk about some updates and what's going on.
Dance,
You know,
monkey,
so
dance.
yeah,
Like,
right.
what? You're going to be on your own channel? How original.
Yeah, well, it's like I explained in the first vlog, like I normally don't do this type of thing, so it's like first it's just like trial run a little bit because you know my our lives aren't like the most interesting, but I mean if we have like updates and stuff going on, you know, maybe I talk a little bit more specifically about what I do like with the 3D printing stuff sometimes, you know.
Right, like my you know, my handle being Hot Rod 54 Chevy. When I go to car shows and swap meets, then I take shit ton of pictures, you know. And I used to like post pictures with, you know, comments because I figured people cared what I had to say. And but like assholes jump on, well, you gotta talk about everything. Why can't you just show the picture? And it's like, eat a dick. It's my shit. I'll post what I want. So that's all I got to say about that.
Hold on.
Oh no. Ian's getting a dick pic.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh.
Was trying to change the camera around. The fuck?
And then he realized his dick was out.
Hello?
Yeah. We still see your thumbnail.
Okay. Yeah, I don't know what's going on. Oh, it. What I'm trying to do is. Okay. The icons in this Hangout, like, aren't very intuitive.
Well, Hangouts isn't intuitive, and don't worry, just one day it just won't be fucking there.
Yeah, I got some Devi, some uppy upper tens about that. But.
We never actually had a, like a discussion about it. I think one week we're just gonna come on and be like, "So Hangouts is dead, huh? Fuck."
Yeah, we're getting, it's like we're getting fired from our own show again.
Right. Like we're gonna have to like, I mean, Google, I love them, but they're not consistent at fucking all. Like, you know,
No.
are we gonna have like are we gonna both have to use Duo or Allo? What the fuck is Allo? Like, I keep seeing it.
Yeah.
Is that a chat app or what the fuck is it? I'm gonna Google it while we're talking.
No, that we might have to. In short, the article was saying that people might have to become basically do what all the pros are already doing. Unfortunately.
What's that?
Like OBS and all that shit.
Well, yeah, but like, you don't video chat with OBS, so you have to like have a video chat app, right?
Well, you do like the Skype or Discord or whatever. You basically chain all that shit together.
Yeah, I mean,
and do like doing this on mobile, like, yeah, you would have to be doing all that shit, and I don't know, man.
I mean, really, if you're like, you know, like say you're Doug popping in every so often, if you have the Discord app, you could just hop in that way.
Yeah, yeah.
And then, like, you know, because that'd be the like least, you know, reliant on a third party bullshit, you know, way to do it. Oh, well, we said goodbye to Aloe on March 12th of 2019. Smarter way to check. So Aloe's gone, huh? Okay. Because I had it on my phone and it like transferred it to my new phone. And I'm like, what the fuck even is it? Oh, it's gone. Okay. Well.
Yeah.
Well,
they were saying they might have like the YouTube has like a YouTube webcam or something, but that's only for like if you're streaming just one yourself.
Right. And that's stupid.
I mean,
it's cool if you have like your phone and you want to do a quick vlog and you don't want to do it from Facebook or from Twitch, you know, you want to do it from YouTube, I guess. I don't know.
Right. And also the article did say that, the Hangouts is basically the, like the last of its kind as far as an all in one type of thing.
I mean, I know guys who love it cause they use it at work and I'm like, yeah, when it fucking works.
Yeah.
And they're like, fuck you, have you used it with like 100 people at a time? And I'm like, okay, sure.
Yeah. And by the way, we specifically mean the Hangouts on Air.
Yeah.
They're actually killing off the regular Hangouts too.
Yeah, because they want to promote the next thing that's not going to be supported by the time I go to use it. I was freaking out because, you know, I was like, I never stream from the channel. I mean, before I had my reason, I didn't have fast enough internet. And then when I did, I didn't have a good enough computer. And I just did the show from, you know, your channel, so I never had to. So when I fucking do it, you know, I'm like, okay, please tell me that today's not the day they got rid of Hangouts. And, like, the little go live with Google Hangouts, that thing isn't there. So I have to search, I have to look for either a link on a website or the video, like, of someone on YouTube doing it. And they're like, so here's how you do it. I'm like, okay.
No, so. Yeah, their bullshit too is like they're not specifying a date yet either. So they're just like having everybody be in like a buffer zone here. To be like, well, you better start getting to what you got to get to.
Yeah.
Before we shut down here. We're not saying when, but.
Right. Better migrate all your shit before, you know.
Yeah.
Like, what was that, like, photo site that everyone's like, well, you better get your pictures off here because it's going away.
Oh, Flickr.
Oh, that went away?
I don't know. I never really used it that much. But
I used it because, like, there were artists that I follow that used it because they wouldn't use Instagram because Instagram censored stuff, and like the one dude I follow is an actual photographer of like models, so he had all these naked chicks. But I mean, that's all, like, I just followed, I think, him and whoever. It was just like you do now. You follow him on Facebook, then you follow him on Instagram, then you follow him on Twitter, then you follow him on MySpace till MySpace dies, and then it's the same people, just different fucking portal, I guess.
Yeah.
So.
But yeah, you, when I'm hosting the show, which is, you know, regularly, it'll still be basically just as easy for you as it was, except when it's like this, then you'll have to be juggling some balls, man. These nuts.
Oh.
You have to be juggling some kind of nuts.
So, like, whoop. Sorry, there it is. I had to put in a... Oh, Flickr is your Yahoo account name, by the way. At least in my case, it was a Yahoo email. I don't know if it had to be... Like, you know, how, like, certain ones are... This, you know, like, Instagram is Facebook. So, I don't know. One of those things.
Yeah. Well, no, man, like, I think you should... You should try go at some vlogs, you know? It's something, it's pretty easy to do, especially if you're just doing, like, a one-take type of thing.
Well, you know, it's... I would if I had something I, you know, thought was worth fucking with.
I mean, like, I know, I'm not making fun of you. I'm saying, like, you could do some kind of pinstriping updates, or, like, if you want to show, like, installing, like, a component or something on your computer, you know?
Yeah, but... That would be a lot more cursing and a fuss. I watch guys do that, and like, they either cut everything out and like, they go, like this one guy was installing a monitor arm, and he carried it in, and he's like, okay, I got to put it on the table, and they look at his table, and he's got two, like folding tables in this room, and they're completely covered with shit. And he goes, I got to clear off all these tables, fuck. And then he cuts to everything's cleared away. He's like, okay, now I can do this.
Yeah. I mean, that type of stuff is a lot of work. I guess maybe what would be good for you is, like you said, yeah, like going to the shows or whatever, just like times where you could just whip out your phone and you want to do something quick, you know?
Right. I mean, it's a lot easier now that I've got a fast phone, because, like, you know, I can just... And the camera in this is actually really... The thing, a lot of people say, oh, OnePlus has never been the phone to get because of the camera. And then when this one came out, they're like, well, you know, the camera is better, but it's still not the reason to get the phone. Well, people also were, A, hacking it with putting the Google camera app on it. And now there have been updates to where I like it better than my first-gen Pixel camera. I'm sure the second and third-gen Pixels are better, but it's pretty good. Yeah. And it even with it in my pocket all day and pulling it out and using it, I carry a glasses cleaning cloth in my pocket just to clean the lens of my camera. I haven't had to use it. Like, I took some pictures right before I came on the show, and I'm like, damn. I don't need to clean anything. It just works fine.
Yeah. I mean, it's right up on the lens, so, like, unless if you got some, like, booger on there, it's not going to really show up, you know?
You said booger.
Yeah. But, like...
I entered the wrong code. They did a double verification. I'm still trying to get onto Flickr. It's like, oh, I thought that where the text was from, I thought it was my code. And it's like, no, that's not it, stupid. So, sorry, what were you saying?
Okay, what was I saying? No, I was like, you're... A lot of the cameras, you know, like you could say this camera is a little bit better than the other or whatever, but really a lot of the cameras are getting a lot of the same shit. Like you're saying, like shooting raw and stuff, that's becoming a standard with doing 4K. I mean, it's like all these companies are basically competing to get against each other to put all the latest and greatest in their phone, which is good for us, you know?
Oh, here we go. I logged in, you know, we'd like to keep all your photos forever for free, including this one, first that you ever uploaded. Also, we have new rules for free accounts. You may need to delete photos exceeding our new limits. You have 151 we can no longer keep for free. It's time to let us know what you'd like to do. Join Pro or delete. Yeah, don't save my shit. Yeah. I don't give a fuck. I'm not paying money. I'm not going to pay. Yep.
I think we'll get along without you, right?
Anyway, so what has Ian been up to?
I'm just basically Just jacking it.
Just jacking it.
Yeah. Now watching these fellers, the doggies.
Aw.
Yeah, I was doing vlogs too, just because I was like kind of bored, and it's seemed kind of interesting, you know. Yeah, I got my Xbox hooked up to this TV, by the way, and it looks really good with the 4K, because it said, hey, we see that you could do a 4K resolution on here. Would you like to change the setting? And I said, fuck yeah, I would.
Fuck yeah.
I brought my external hard drive, and since you could have Kodi on there, I was trying to get that working, but for some reason the Xbox, like, it wasn't really recognizing my hard drive for some reason, so like it saw it was in there, but like it was like acting like really slow or something. It might be that like it's like really full, it's like barely got a gig left or something on there, so maybe that's the problem.
Maybe.
I don't know.
Lloyd's saying, hey, your boy Ian never, you know, wants the game with me.
I'm sorry, dude, man. Like, I've been, I don't know what, if I have any games that he plays on there.
I don't know.
What I'll do have you to have? Check out, well, I've been doing a lot of the Game Pass stuff lately, but the games I actually own now is, like, the Mafia 3. I have Red Dead Redemption 2, which I haven't even played yet.
Mm-hmm. I think he said he already beat it.
Well, most everybody on the planet's already been beating it. I mean, they even did a South Park episode with it.
Yeah.
About it, you know?
Uh-huh.
But, by the way, this is my brother's fish tank here. They, I forget what kind of fish he says. He has a betta fish, I guess, that he's keeping at his girlfriend's house while they're on vacation. But, like I was saying in the vlog, you could turn it on, off, and then they have, like, a night mode with, like, it's like a black light or something. I guess that helps them sleep. I don't know. But, yeah, I mean, I'd watch some of your vlogs. I'd check it out, man. See what Frankie's up to sometimes, you know?
Yeah, I just gotta get off my ass and do it.
But I think it was kind of fun because it's like, hey, I made that and it wasn't that hard, you know? Nah. It's kind of nice because, like, I figure you're the type of person, too, that likes, like, you take pictures a lot, don't you, like you said, and you probably yeah. like keeping memories and shit, you know?
Memories.
If we can't get money, if you're not really, I wouldn't do it for the money. I would just do it for because it's good to have memories.
I like
one, because it's fun, and two, because YouTube ain't going to give you shit.
Right. I like to be on Facebook, and it goes, 6 years ago, you posted this. And I'm like, Jesus, that long ago?
Yeah.
So, what are you drinking on tonight?
Okay, so, I mean, I've been drinking, I'll arrange it here. It'll just be easier. So, I actually got a live while you're here.
Oh.
Ice, and then the Fanta pineapple, my typical, and then some toilet water.
Mm.
And a little bit of that orange vanilla Coke, which I've been nursing on for a couple days, but it's a little bit. Yeah, I mean, it's not that flat, actually, because it's like, it's still got carbonation.
Well, but my computer froze. Can you see me?
Nope. I can hear you, though.
Yeah, I can see you. It's, I don't know what's doing here, but I don't know if it's Google or my computer or, you know, just, yeah.
Do you see any, oh, there you go.
So I got a 2 liter of the OG here.
Oh, really?
Yeah, yeah.
Are you just drinking out of the 2 liter?
Oh, no, I got ice.
Oh, okay.
I was drinking, I mean, when I had my pizza, I drink out of the bottle because it was cold out of their fridge. So I was, but then I put it back in my fridge and I went and got some ice because I was like, I'm not gonna be sitting here for 2 to 4 hours with a warm ass drink. That's no. And then I got, you know, toilet water.
So. Sweet.
Anyway, by the way,
Have you heard of something? I just heard because I listened to the Howard Stern show and they were talking about this new thing. Now that's it's called ginger beer.
That's not a new thing, but okay.
Well, I guess the brand is new. I forget what the brand name was, but I guess it's not. It's called beer, but it's not alcoholic. It's like root beer.
Yeah. But, like what I've been drinking on the show, the sarsaparilla and root beer and birch beer. It's in the same vein as that. Yes.
Yeah. But no, ginger beer is ginger. Basically like ginger ale, but it's the real stuff. I guess apparently the company was saying the actual ginger ale, that's bullshit. It was just like flavored stuff. It really didn't actually help you.
Well, yeah, like real, like root beer is supposed to have root in it. No, it's all chemical shit now. Same with sarsaparilla is not actual sarsaparilla. The sarsaparilla is a plant. And it's no, not anymore. They just put some old shit in there and flavor it. But the birch beer that I get at Sioux City, I think that's one of my new favorites. Next time I go to the store, I'm gonna buy a lot more of it because I bought a couple last time and I drank it like right away because it's like a kind of like a cream soda kind of. It's got like a smooth vanilla-y flavor.
Yeah,
I enjoy it.
It's interesting seeing that, like noticing that, hey, I actually really like this type of drink because, like, I never knew I really liked pineapple drinks.
Yeah. I mean, I like pineapple. When we were in Jamaica, I had it with, like, every meal. I never had plantains until I went to Jamaica, and they're delicious.
Yeah.
Fried.
But, I mean, how often do you discover, like, you actually like a new thing when you're older, you know?
Well, you know, it's you gotta try new stuff.
Yeah.
At a certain point, I realized I'm like, oh, I've just been a bitch this whole time saying, nah, I don't like that. Never open it up and put it in my mouth. Now it's just like, I haven't had that. Let me try that shit. Nah, it's gross.
Well, we're getting older. We get stuck in our ways, don't we, Frank?
I mean, yeah. Before you know it, the world's passed you by. When my wife and I got married, and we went to Jamaica, and my dad and brother went, and my dad said he had never been outside of the country, and he had said if he had known there was a place like where we were at in Jamaica, he wouldn't have been in Ohio. It would have been that fucking place in Jamaica. So
why in my day, in Fallout, you actually had to earn your own shit.
That's right. So anyway, you want to get into the video of the week because it's like already an hour since we started.
Oh, yeah. Hold on.
Cappy.
By the way, let me. I was actually going to try to have Nate on here. I'm going to send him a link. I totally forgot about that. Yeah, because he wanted to do. He wanted to come on the show, maybe.
Okay. So, what the?
Yeah. Do the music. Be like, video of the week.
Oh. It's not hide and seek. It's the video of the week.
Something like that. Yeah.
I just had that in my head. I started dicking around with the keyboard, like going, trying to make it match my voice, and like trying to do it all serious.
Super cereal.
Yeah, well, like, you know, like there's little, you know, like we're in the singing psychic from Howard Stern. She would do like a little 10-second song about her little prediction.
Right.
It was always the same song, but like with the words a little different. You don't remember that? Howard tricked her into singing that Christopher Reeve would get up and walk again.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
He's like, nah, he's dead. So what in the Sam Hill has this guy got?
He's got a 200 watt pop, laser.
Getting
And
laser beams. Is that like a.
laser.
I saw a magnifying glass. I'm like, is he burning the fuck out of some ants? I don't. He looks like the kid who tried to take your lunch money. I'm gonna beat you up and I'm gonna hit you with this laser.
Well, a skinny version of that, I guess.
Well, you know, back when I didn't have much lunch money or much lunch. I told some guy today what I, like, well, after I got my pizza, how much I had. And he's like, hey, don't wuss out, eat the whole thing. I was like, I was gonna. And I'm like, I'm already halfway done. He's like, what the fuck?
Yeah, go back to that one frame. You see that giant thick laser? It's like that's not a special effect or anything. That's like actually how it is.
That's I like he said on the suggested video, he's like testing illegal blue lasers from eBay.
And making them stronger.
So why is he trying to say, here's why you don't do this? This guy burned down his house and burned his mother's face off.
He's basically like a young mad scientist, basically. He just does it for the hell of it, you know?
He's trying to figure out how he can take over the world, Pinky.
I guess. I mean, I don't know what he does for a living besides YouTube. I think he's actually got like a normal 9-to-5 job or whatever, but
Yes, Patreon. I don't know how many people. I gotta click
yeah.
on his Patreon and go to. Let me open another tab here. Hold up. Hold on. Okay. He has 213 patrons, making $737 per month.
Yeah, then that's just like side money then.
Yeah, I mean, unless he's like that dude living in a tiny house. I tell you about that video.
No.
There was a guy living in this tiny house. It was this, you know how you get suggested videos that you would never look up, and you're like, I gotta see what this is. And like, my wife watches, flip, like the flip houses and all that. So like the newest thing on those HGTV things is tiny houses. You know, people who get them and like what their experience is like going to like a 12 by 12 house. When they used to have, a nice house. Well, this guy literally has a 10 foot by 10 foot shed that he's living in, and he's like a hippie who's like trying to reduce his carbon footprint. And he, the whole video, he never wore shoes. He doesn't have a car. He rides a bicycle everywhere. He's on somebody else's property. His water is like rainwater he caught from somewhere. And I was watching it like, oh boy, how's he doing this? And then he goes, and over here, he's like, here's my compost pile. Here's my, where I grow my whatever, whatever. And he's like, and here's where I grow my toilet paper. He's like, the plants are so soft. Look, you can, he rubs his face in it. Softest, and it's a member of the lilac family, so it smells great. And I just go here and pluck a couple leaves, and I'll show that to my wife. And she's like, nope, hell no, nope.
Yeah.
He has a 5 gallon bucket that he shits in, basically. And then
Shit.
he sprinkles sawdust on top of it, and then once it gets so full, it's compost. And then he takes showers in rainwater, and I'm like, I was like, he can't smell too good. I mean, what, does he use soap? I go, I'm sure it's air quotes soap. Because he showed his shelf, like here's all his clothes. Like it's like four t-shirts and he's like in some essential oil, so that means he's stinking. So
Bank.
this laser guy just caught your interest because he's
Yeah, I mean it's. I've been, like lasering with the dogs and stuff. So it's just a bullshit video. Most interesting video I've seen during a week, anyways.
I mean,
nothing really to learn from it. I mean, I try to do mostly, you know, like informative and educational stuff for Video of the Week a lot of times, but this one is just, who gives a shit?
Right. If I got something that's so crazy it catches my eye, or something that tells me something I didn't know about, or a topic of discussion that I would like to discuss.
Yeah, there's not much to discuss here.
just look at that laser. Look, he's wearing short sleeves, no gloves. He's wearing because, you know, full laser is going to always go to your eye. It's not going to, you're not going to drop it and blow your fucking arm off.
Yeah, he said what's crazy about that high of wattage of laser is just the laser dot shining on the wall could make you go blind.
Well, so what's to keep the gun from overheating?
I guess he's got like a lot of heat sinks and stuff on all that shit.
Well, yeah, but like the barrel, if you will, is literally just copper tubing.
I don't know how he does that. I mean, obviously he knows that he hasn't blown himself up yet, so.
Yet.
yeah.
No.
When I say yet.
I told you I got an associate's in mechanical engineering. When I was in college, one of our assignments was to design a thing that would shoot jello, but it wanted to do it in an arc, because if you did it in a straight linear path, then it was technically a weapon. So during the presentation, there were two guys showing their gun, which looked like an Uzi, which was really cool looking. It was made out of PVC and had a spring, on it to, you pull the, one tube back and it goes through the other and shoots the jello, right? And he's like, yeah, you notice when you pull this back, he's like, you see how that spring on the gun lands right up with that big old wound on my arm? That's not a coincidence.
Yeah.
That's just why I see this guy going, see, this is how I lost my fingers here.
Well, the thing is like, he orders a lot of stuff from eBay, like that one video, but also he like actually cannibalizes stuff. It's like Bill and Ted, with Station. He just like rips electronics. Like he cannibalized like a laser projector for parts and all that shit, So like he knows what all the individual components of like circuitry and stuff does,
So he needs a shirt that says "I void warranties."
Yeah, he just destroys them. He's like, what the fuck is a warranty?
Right. I mean, just the angle, though, that like, of the stock piece of the back, how it's going into that big piece of, I'm guessing, steel. The angle it's at makes it look to me like it's held on by, like, two screws, and as soon as you tilt it, it'll, come loose and just...
Yeah, he's basically a hacksmith with this type of stuff, you know?
I mean, this looks like a weapon you would see in Fallout. Let me say that.
Yeah.
And not something you would make, given that, if you had the means for an actual weapon, you wouldn't be buying this fucking thing. If I had to buy either a flamethrower from the Boring Company or this, I'm buying the fucking not a flamethrower.
Well, yeah, that's the thing, is a lot of his stuff is like, it's not... like nice and neat in like a package and shit. It's like you can barely take it anywhere. But like in a lot of his video, what?
Put that in your luggage. Try to get on a fucking plane.
Yeah,
sir. What the fuck is this? Spread your cheeks.
Right, but no, you like he's like the safety glasses that came with some of the stuff he buys from eBay. He's like, I'm not even trusting this shit. He goes straight to like a straight up welding mask,
Yeah. Well, would you like to get into my video of the week, sir?
Sure.
All right, hold on. I got to adjust my seat. Nico. Okay, so my video of the week. You remember when I showed the video of that tour of the Unbox Therapy studio and they had that wall of TVs and shit?
Oh, yeah.
Those lights, and you're like, man, when's he going to use that set? Well, he doesn't use it on Unbox Therapy. He has another channel called Lou Later. I think it's a whole different channel. Hold on. Let me look real quick. Oh, this is Later Clips, but stuff from Lou Later, which appeared... Anyway, am I subscribed to this one? I guess not. Hold on. Subscribed.
Subscribe.
Yeah, see, I'm subscribed to Lou Later, but this is a clip.
See you later, Lou Later.
Right. No, he does. It basically, I think it's because the setup, it looks like a late night TV show, you know, like Conan or something. Or the Late Late Show or whatever.
Yeah.
He, you know, he does a little, you know, talking point. And like I said, this is a clip, apparently. I didn't realize. I thought it was like the entire thing, but it's a segment of the show. And it's like from this episode here, which I don't care about the whole episode, but the context of this clip is the end of ad blocker, which is a thing we talked about on the show, how Google was basically getting rid of ad blocker except for their enterprise users.
Yeah, yeah.
So, you know, he talked about how he can see both sides of it because he is a content creator and also a content consumer. Yeah. And I mean, anyone on YouTube is a content creator, but if your livelihood is YouTube videos, then yeah, you're a content creator. Like him and Linus and, you know, those guys. Okay, yeah, that's what they fucking do for a living. They, you know.
Well, the thing is the content creators, they don't like doing the ads. I mean,
well,
if they didn't have to do them, they wouldn't.
Well, yeah, but I mean, like, oh, you know, the other one, like, there are ones who, like, one of the guys I follow, you know, is like, I don't care if you follow or subscribe. He's like, but join my Patreon, because he has patrons. His girlfriend has her own Patreon. He's a patron of her. She's a patron of him, which is cute but stupid, but whatever. I pay you $5 a month to see you. You pay $5 a month to see me.
Aww.
So, but anyway, the thing is, you know, like, Adblock, you know, the talking point we got into is, you know, when his instance, he uses it for the show, because when you're bringing up, like, I use it for the show, because when you're showing an article, the ads now are just in your fucking face. You can, it's like, do I want to go to a website? Oh, no, not really. You know, the reason people use Facebook, like, that people, you know, the whole argument on the news is, oh, people get all their news from Facebook instead of going, and well, what are you going to do? You go to a website, and even, like, you know, the Wall Street Journal or whatever, they're like, hey, it's like, pay $1 a month and subscribe to us. No. Or, you know, you can go to Facebook where someone just shows the headline and you can just read it there. Well, of course, duh, I'll go to that, because you go to a website, any fucking website now, and it's, you just bombarded with unskippable, clickable ads that just jump in front of what you're trying to do.
Yeah, I've heard some people with some of the ads on shit, like, it takes over their whole phone, and they even when they close it out, the ad is still playing.
Yes, like,
it's almost like malware.
Yeah, when like Facebook first launched videos in feeds, it was autoplay videos with sound, and for a while, every time they would do an update, the sound would come back on, even though you turn it off by default, it would come back on anyway.
Dun, bah, bah.
And like my phone and my tablet, I always have it default to not have sound anyway, because like if my wife's in bed and I read stuff online through apps that are ad supported, which I don't mind a little pop up that, you know, I wait 3 seconds and I can click skip this ad, because technically I viewed the ad, so I did my part. But when it has fucking music and just noise, and the volume button, like the turn sound off mute button is all the way at the bottom that you can't get to. At 2 a.m, you know, when I'm sitting there reading and she's trying to sleep, my wife gets mad. So,
well, the thing about YouTube though is like the ads could be so much better though. Like what they should do is, because a lot of content creators even say that the ads interrupt the flow of the actual thing where they're it skips to the ad right in the middle of them talking. But I guess that they don't really have control control. I don't know too much about it, but like I guess there's not really a whole lot of control for when the actual ad placements are, but if you could have like pauses and stuff for commercials, that it would be good. But I guess that would kind of be like the content creator would have to do that, and I don't
Well,
know.
it's stupid because they got rid of what was it, cards? Like, you could, a content creator could go, see my previous video on this, probably here, and he points up to the corner, and then suggested video comes up. Well, it'd be great if that popped up and it was like, check out this ad for this, like Linus could get up and say, oh, well, we're doing this because of a product from, this company, and you can click on it if you want to go, instead of having to watch a stupid. Like they're going to the market now, like you said, it's they're going to where the sponsor, they the video makers have to include a 10, 20-second commercial in the beginning of their video because an ad pops up and people skip it. So now they gotta put a baked in fucking commercial. They're going like the old days of radio when it's like brought to you by Miss Merriweather's butter. If you want butter, there's none better. Merriweather's butter.
Well, like I don't know about you, but I'd sit through a couple of minutes of ads just to get them done with at the fucking beginning instead of it like getting shitloads of throughout the thing,
Oh
you
yeah.
know?
But like that's a is a meme now, like because there's a little yellow dot where there's gonna be an ad and the like a 20-minute ad. If it's you can tell which ones are popular. Because if the video is not popular, it's got maybe one ad, if any. But if the video is popular, every 5 seconds, there's a fucking ad.
Yeah, and guess what happens if you accidentally close out the video and you click back on it?
What?
You get an ad again,
Right.
even though
Now,
you didn't already watch the fucking thing.
right. And if you scrub the video and go past the ad, it doesn't care. It's going to play anyway. It's like, oh, you meant to watch that ad, didn't you? Now, see, I have this page loaded up. It's the YouTube, .com. I have the ad blocker on, and I have just this one video up. Ad blockers tell me it blocked 11 ads.
Oh my God.
So let me turn it off.
Take it off.
And let me restart the. Oh,
Diamonds.
there's the ad you're talking about. And now it's one of two, by the way. They go, you're watching an ad, and then right after that, you've got to watch another one.
I mean, I guess it's the same amount of time, but they just want more and more money from various they want to try to fit as many in there as they can, I guess.
Enable ad block. Okay, so anyway, I'm just like I said, doing it so that you're not bombarded with shit. Now, he is promoting YouTube Premium as a service, which if YouTube is in your pocket, if you have to, if that's your bread and butter, of course you're going to say subscribe to their premium service because YouTube,
Yeah.
already they don't want you to go to Patreon and. If you can get kickbacks from YouTube by advertising their services, why wouldn't you? Well, I wanted to like YouTube Premium, the previous iteration, YouTube Pro or whatever the fuck it was called, or Red. When it was Red, that's what it was. When I tried the free version of Red, and like I said, I still got ads on my Roku. I don't know if it's the Roku's fault, but I paid, $10 a month, technically. Because I had a three month free, and then like I used Google reward points, so I didn't have to actually pay anything. But I'm glad I didn't because I still had ads. And
Yeah, that's bullshit, man.
the originals are meh. And then they said, okay, we're getting rid of Red. We're still going to do it, but you can do YouTube Premium. And they went from $9 a month to $11.99. So you're raising the
Yeah.
fucking price. And before it was, if you do the Red, you get was it Google Music free, right? Well,
Right.
now YouTube has its own service. It's YouTube Music, which is in his explanation, he says it's like Spotify. It's not really. YouTube Music sucks. I mean, I have yet to actually find what I'm looking for. Like, let's see. Can I pull it up from the website? YouTube Music, okay. Videos. El Mundo now. Is there
Oh,
anybody up?
Mondo.
Yeah. Is there anyone that I've actually heard of here? Playlists, YouTube session. I mean, like, 1 million subscribers. There's one, two, there's two, four, six, eight, 10, 12, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's 11 playlists here. How many videos? I mean, is this that it? That's it. These are all the videos. I
Well,
mean,
it's just like that. Who's that guy that was or that channel? Was it like that T series that was actually gonna beat out PewDiePie and the subscribers? Like, I don't really care for PewDiePie, but I've never even heard of T series before. It's like some.
other countries are probably big, but I mean, this is it. Like, YouTube music events. There's that many. And
Wow.
you can't, normally if it says, here's a suggested b bunch of videos, you could click next and then next and next and next. No, here you
Looking
click next
next.
and that's it. Where's the. No. Because,
Yeah.
like, well, because I asked my. I used to be able to ask your Android device to play a song on YouTube, and it would go playing blah 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 on YouTube. Now, if you say YouTube, it goes playing blah 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 on YouTube Music. Could not find blah 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 on YouTube Music. You're like, God damn it, that's not what I wanted you to do.
Damn it, Bobby.
So why would I pay for 12 videos, I guess? I don't know. I don't know. That's regular YouTube's better, and then YouTube Originals, those suck. They're not any good. Oh, ad free and offline, so you can download videos and watch them in the back, and you can watch stuff in the background. There are extensions on Chrome that let you do this and other ways around it.
Well, I mean they. I, me and they do like that Cobra Kai, but like you can't base a whole platform on that though. You know,
Now,
it's like they'll cling to little nuggets, I guess, but the
I
thing I
mean,
was gonna say though is like if they decide to start getting rid of or like banning like any reference or links or whatever with Patreon, that's gonna be a downfall, man.
they're flagging people. Like, for a minute, they didn't want you to, if you had a Twitch stream coming up, I think it was Linus was the one that everyone's like, ooh, they got flagged. So, like, the next day, the guy that I follow, he's like, hey, we should hang out, and I'll be hanging out at the place I'm usually hanging out. You know what I'm talking about? I can't say it. So, hold on, I gotta
Yeah.
refill my beverage here.
We could rant all day about YouTube sucks, but
I mean, we're just saying suggested changes because they always say, like, with politics, if you want to make changes, go out there and make them. You can't. I can't change YouTube, so. I can't. I'm not gonna go out and make my own video channel and be like fucking YouTube Music and have six videos on it.
well, the problem is tell me when the last time you got a hold of YouTube. I'll wait. You know, I mean,
Even Linus, who has contacts, can't fucking get a hold of me.
I guess if you're big, you could get, you know some people at YouTube,
Well.
but I mean.
No, like I said, Linus has two different reps and they tell him two different things. I mean,
Yeah.
on. But left hand doesn't know what the right hand's doing, I guess.
Well, and like, I mean, there is a lot more that they could fix with YouTube, and it, because it, you know, they're like, well, we can only put so much manpower in it. That's why you have to do automation with everything. But I mean, there is, you still do a better job, you know?
And our
There's,
show goes down.
yeah.
No, it's
At least
like,
they're by.
but the whole thing here is, ad blocker, and I understand, like, the service is going to go away if they don't have a way to pay for it. And I personally, I didn't want ad blocker at all. Like, I, because the YouTube ads, I still watch them on Roku. I still get get ads and I don't mind because I'll see a trailer for something I don't watch regular TV. I would miss. I go, oh, this new movie's coming out. I didn't even fucking hear about that. Like, there's a stupid movie coming out now that I actually want to see about the guy who's a struggling musician and he plays a Beatles cover song and nobody remembers the Beatles except him.
Yeah.
And that looks stupid, but I want to see it because it's original. It's not a fucking rehashing of The Grinch or Cinderella.
Well, the thing is like, me and you are, like, nerds and stuff, and we have specific tastes and things, but, I mean, most people could tell, you could tell when the ads suck, and they basically do, you know, there's nothing really interesting about some car commercials or this or that, you know, it's not really
insurance commercials entertaining. Right now, because, like, you got Flo, and you got, even with, is it Dennis Quaid is in the commercials now for e-insurance? He's like, shouldn't charge, safe drivers shouldn't be charged the same as not safe drivers. Ah, and the guy drops his coffee and he's like, by the way, I'm really a safe driver. I'm just pretending to be a not safe driver. Bye, Dennis Quaid.
Yeah, those aren't bad, but just like the specific commercials with like cars and like Audi or something, it's like, they're like, oh, this is the beginning of a dawn of a new thing. You know, it's like they're, like, right. God's gift to man or something with this car.
And now we've got a car, which you've never seen before. Or, like, I'm almost 37 years old. I have yet to see a perfume or cologne commercial that I knew what the fuck it was until the end when they say, you know, CK1. I'm like, oh. Because you'll be sitting there going, okay, there's ladies in ball gowns dancing. There's a guy in jeans with no shirt on. There's a fucking tiger in the middle of the room. What the? CK1. Oh, okay. That makes sense.
Yeah, like, they'll do, like, a touching moment with, like, a mom and a daughter or something as if it has anything to do with the fucking car, you know?
Or, you know, fake focus groups. People gather around, oh, wow, that's a Chevy truck. Oh, wow, there's a bunch of Chevy trucks. Yeah, you're brought into a place by Chevy. Of course there's going to be a bunch of Chevy trucks. So,
yeah.
I mean, people just don't... An ad in itself is an obtrusive thing, and people don't want it, but it's the only way for a company to make money. Like, who was the senator was asking a guy from Twitter or somewhere, he's like, how do you make money if you don't charge your customers? And he's like, we run ads, Senator.
Yeah. Well, I'm saying that, like, it doesn't... It shouldn't be that way. You should let the product speak for itself, because if you get too obtrusive, you start having people hate you and stuff, you know? It's like those people in the mall that, like, they're like stalkers almost, you know, when you walk those kiosk things or whatever.
Yeah. It's like Dave Chappelle bit. It's like debt consolidation, gambling, pop-ups.
Yeah. I mean, there's commercials, like you said, where they actually put entertainment effort into it.
Right, production value and comedy. Like,
yeah.
I really think that if they just tailored the ads to the format of the show, which all the Techiverse stuff is together. Like, Lou is lumped in with Linus, is lumped in with all those other people. You know it's going to be tech-related. Just do a fucking commercial for a phone, or a video game console, or even a fucking video game. Or just look at the title of the video and throw in something related to that. Because every comment, if someone goes, here's my new desk, and in the description, the first thing they say is, it's an IKEA blah, blah, blah. I bought it at blah, 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 and this is how much it cost. And then you scroll down, and every comment, yo, where'd you get that sick desk at? Hey, where's that desk, man? Can I get a link?
A lot of these videos that they do are, yeah, that's a whole ad technically, you know?
Like when the fucking, the room tours and everything, it's always, what the fuck's a Signum? Where do you get that? What is that thing under your desk?
Yeah. Where do you know where a lot of people pissed about that, when Linus started doing like Dollar Shave Club or whatever that is?
Oh. I remember the Dyson one.
Yeah, because I mean, those are kind of a little bit, you know, like OT or whatever, but
topic.
Yeah, off topic.
They prefer Tunnel Bear and fucking LimeWire. Isn't this brought to you
Those
by?
are still kind of techy, I guess, you know.
I mean, the glass wire. That was a glass wire. The one, like the one where I saw that comic, and just like everybody reading the comments, like, dude, I could hear, I could feel this commercial. Because Linus has said it so many times. It's probably just one recording over and over and over again. But.
Well, I don't mind like ads for NordVPN and stuff. Those are actually good products, you know. I know, like Floyd uses it and stuff, and I'd like to use it, except just money, bro. You know.
I'm gonna download some money.
Yeah.
Download your RAM. But anyway, that was my thing. Was it's a discussion I have articles about it, basically just because. Since you summarized yours, I'll just throw mine out there. It technically is going away from Chrome, but not all Chrome-based browsers. Chromium-based, I guess.
Oh,
so,
okay.
So, like, Brave and Vivaldi and et cetera, et cetera. They'll still support it, whether or not Chrome does or not. I don't know to what end. I know at one point Chrome's going to say, oh, yeah? Take this shit. But...
Yeah.
Let me actually throw in the article real quick. Throw it up. Because I don't have a whole lot of articles this week. Hold on. Okay. Zoom in hats. Put some black on it. Okay.
Put some black on it.
Yeah, because it's, you know, it was all white.
Yeah.
Despite having a common Chromium code base, browser makers like Brave, Opera, and Vivaldi don't have plans on crippling support for Adblocker. So, it's going to be an interesting thing to see. Like I said, I only really use it for the show, because I don't go off the beaten path. I don't go to sites, you know, like... It used to be, don't go to sketchy sites because you'll get a virus. And they're like, oh, I got a virus. Oh, you were looking for porn or you were stealing movies. Now it's like, oh, I had a fucking pop-up. Oh, you must have been trying to find out the weather.
You know, another way you can avoid that is by going through Kodi.
Well, there's also Craft Computing. He does a video on it where if you make a pfSense router... You can run a script and do whole home ad blocking. So everything in your house won't have ads.
Yeah.
I don't know how. It's very involved, and I don't know what all works with it. I didn't do it. I'm fucking late. I'm a tinkerer, but I'm only to a point.
Well, like, sometimes ads, like, at least for video game, for, like, mobile games and shit, they'll give you an option to mute it, and I do that all the time.
I hate it when they don't, and, like, you gotta... hurry up and press it before, you know, it gets really loud, because ads are always louder than the TV shows and shit. That was
they
actually
put on max volume.
That was actually a lawsuit, like, because that actually was a thing. Everyone kind of noticed it, and then it was really a thing, and it's still a thing. Like, ads are all the way up, and then when the TV show comes back, and then we're back to the... You turn up, you need to hear what the fuck the guy said, and the commercial comes on and it blows your fucking ear during the part. So...
Yeah, I noticed that with a couple of my mobile games that I have where the volume is maxed, and I'm trying to listen to like the podcast or something on the same phone, and it's like there's no, I guess Android has a limitation where you can't like adjust different apps volumes and shit.
Yeah. So, you want to get into stations?
Yeah.
Station. Okay. What is your theme this week, sir?
My theme is something that caught my eye a little bit.
Uh-huh. Ooh, ooh. Something that caught your eye?
Yeah.
Hold on. Continue.
Like colorful kind of setups.
Uh-huh.
My second one breaks the colorful rule, though. Well, just something like as interesting. Maybe they have some discussions around them. Maybe, you know, discussion pieces.
conversation piece. Huh?
Yep.
Hold on. So you said what was your theme? Go ahead. Say
discussion
it again.
Pieces.
I don't know. What did you initially say?
Conversation piece or something to catch your eye.
Got him. Caught your eye. For those who can't see because they're listening to this, which is no one. It's a circle game, as they say. So
yeah.
So yeah, this one, other than the goofy racing chair and the big ass windows, I like the big desk and the large mouse mat, large monitor. That's an AOC monitor too. They make an ultra wide.
Oh really?
Yeah, I don't know anything about it though. Let me see. Yeah, if your window open, I wish I could do that. It's like 110 degrees outside. It was 80, 85 or so today. Just about perfect. If it's higher than 75, it's a no for me, dog. And then the whole discussion about weather and humidity.
Well, when you start sweating and you're just sitting there, that's not. You might want to shut the windows.
Well, I mean, here in our land, I don't know about your neck of the woods, but like it's been rainy for like ever.
Yeah, it was raining all week.
They said in the state we've got like the most rain in the past 18 months. It's like the wettest season ever, and it's going to be like that till August.
Yeah.
It is the suck.
People still say that the weather's not fucked up.
Yeah. It's just as Jeebus intended.
Yep.
Scroll past all these comments. I know I have this. I gotta have the fucking fan on. It's like low. Just low or high? I think that's high.
Low.
Just right on my face, because it's like I don't roll my window down when I'm driving, and like have the air blow me. I have to have AC on.
Oh, Frank doesn't stick his head out the window.
Nah. Oh, this one's only 1080. It says what AOC monitor is that? Search. Shopping.
I have to admit though, I get kind of bored with like monitor and TV videos. Like, I didn't even really feel like doing that 8K shit last week, but it was all I could find, you know.
It's like, oh, who the fuck's gonna watch anything in 8K? But.
Well, I liked when he tried to do that 16K setup. That was interesting just because there was so many problems and stuff just trying to get the shit to work, you know?
Well, because that was on them, because it wasn't one monitor that did 16K. It was like,
right. What,
16 monitors?
Yeah.
But, anyway. Station number dos. Oh, I got a stream deck. Oh. I mean, a Keurig, G Fuel, TV.
Looks like a decent, like, podcasting type of setup, you know?
Yeah, I mean, it's got a little light there that would drive me nuts to be right next to.
Yeah.
Horrible chair that looks cool but probably feels like butt.
Well, it's glad. Like there's we can appreciate some setups, but we wouldn't use them, you know.
Yes. Well, like those speakers are, I'm sure sound comes out of them. The webcam, I'm sure. The webcam, I'm sure, records, you know, camera.
Well, it's got to be better than yours.
No.
Or works better, at least.
No. My camera works fine. It's the hub that sucks, remember?
Yeah, no, I'll just get on you. And actually, today it was... It seemed like it was decent. I didn't notice any flickering today.
I mean, it did, but... You're on your phone, so what do you know? But anyway, yeah, this is aight, but caught your eye, huh? He's really, really slim pickings on the stations, huh?
Well, I was in a hurry.
Gotcha. Or I thought I sent another one.
You see, you get this shit throughout the week. You got time.
Oh no, I crammed at the last minute too.
Oh, hey, you did too.
Yeah, you got a weeb station here.
Yes, I do.
You got it's half weeb.
Half weeb.
Well, see, if it's a couple station, then either the guy is a weeb and his wife is okay with all the girls, or the girl likes looking at girly girls. Either one.
Well, if it's half weeb, it's nothing. It doesn't exist.
Anyway. But yeah, I like this one. They got the shelf with all their waifus hanging off of it, and then they got the portal gun. And
they must get some money. They got a lot of tiles, don't they?
The Nano Leafs. How many come in the default pack? I can't remember.
I don't know. I mean, that probably one pack probably covers it, but they make it look like it's a lot in that setup, I guess.
Hold on. I'm going to go.
They kind of like spread it out more, I guess. I mean, it's kind of, I guess it's kind of like an R form, like arranging them too, because it's like a lot of people just clump them together in one like blob, you know?
Right. Well, okay. So this one comes with 9 panels for $200.
Holy shit.
7, 8, 9. So $200 could get this, and then 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12.
Mania.
So the one on the left is just one of these. The one on the right is one of these plus 59. So that's 260.
I want your mania.
It's funny though, like if you frequent Reddit and see all these battle stations in the comments, you always see people, what are these colored triangles? I keep seeing they're Nanoleaf. No one ever actually fucking reads it. It's always a comment, which is like stupid. If you read the comments, you know it's in there. And then like, or you see someone post, hey, just got the colored lights because they know that everyone wants them. Or, you know, I don't know if they're worth it, but they're sure pretty. And I'm like, eh. For what they are, I think you could really make your own a lot better.
Yeah. I see a lot of people are getting into those Hue bulbs and shit. And like those Hue bars or whatever.
Yeah.
But that shit is still way too overpriced for my taste. Yeah.
Well, I mean, like, just get you an LED fucking light bulb and put it in whatever. And like mine's, you know, it came with a remote and it was like, I think $10.
Oh, well, you see the Hue things, actually, I guess they have this new thing now where they interacts with the Razer software, so, like, your Hue lights will flash when you get a kill on
Fortnite
or something, you know?
Yeah, if you got Razer shit. That was actually a video I had not too long ago.
Yeah.
Let me read about this setup now. The wife is on the left and my own. Oh, okay.
See, this is a discussion.
She is a huge fan of Sailor Moon and Alice in Wonderland. Thus, her favorite color is blue.
Okay.
I built the desk and added the lighting. I was trying to avoid the Nanoleaf lights, even though I really like the look. I considered 3D print my own, but saw some Nanoleaf kits on sale at a local shop and figured, why not?
Yeah. Well, honestly, that's a lot of printing material for 3D printing. It'd almost be better if you were to get, like, what did that dude make it out of? In that one video, didn't you do a video of the week where you made them out of some kind of plastic material or something?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know if he like 3D printed them or what. Like, because really all you need is something that'll diffuse the color.
Yeah.
And like that could be held paper. They make a paper that's semi-translucent.
Yeah, well, I mean, you could just get some of that, like, like that clear, like if, because they have like picture frames and stuff with just like a clear sheet of plastic or whatever. If you just like scuff those up and make it cloudy, with some sandpaper, you could even do that. And you could actually, it's thin enough where you, if you like score it with like a X-Acto knife or whatever, and then just like break it off on the side of your desk, it'll have a nice clean cut, That, what do you call it? The plexiglass or whatever.
I'm trying to see the parts list and description. Oh, that's right. I have a global black on, so it got rid of the scrub thing here. Where did he get the schematic? Parts used. LED strip, LED controller, acrylic diffuser sheet. Yeah, it's a piece of fucking acrylic.
Yeah, acrylic, that's the word I was searching for too.
I was looking at how much are this? Width of a sheet. What's 400 millimeters?
400 millimeters?
Yeah, that's as wide as
It's,
they go.
well, it's almost half of a meter, so that's like 1.5, 2 feet, somewhere between there.
Okay, so 250 millimeter would be the right size then.
Yeah, probably, yeah.
Okay, let's go 250 by 250. Those are 7.54 great big pounds. Oh,
Yeah,
one.
acrylic sheets are that they are pretty expensive. That's why I tend to like I'll get them just like I've gotten a couple sheets just from the dollar store for the like picture frames, Because like if you actually order that shit like a lot of times when you order shit for what it's meant to be for, it's a lot more expensive than when you cannibalize it from something else.
Right. I mean,
I've noticed that.
you could just buy acrylic, like plain clear acrylic, and then spray it with like frosted glass,
Yeah.
paint, and
Well,
make
like I say,
it.
you could do that. You could do that, or you could just sand it. I mean, one, the like if you're handling it a lot, I guess you would have to worry about the coating coming off since it's on a slick surface. But I guess you could probably do both. Like if you lightly sand it and then you like get like a really cloudy type of spray paint on there. It depends on the amount of cloudiness level you want to go for, I guess.
Right, the one thing I saw on like I think it was Reddit once, the guy made his own, but he didn't do this. He got like pieces of just paper and like styrofoam and then put LED strips around it so the
Yeah.
actual squares didn't light up, but behind it lit up just like typical LEDs would, and it provided contrast, which is really all you're trying to do.
Right.
But it depends on what you're trying to do. I for what you do, eh. So, but yeah, I'm gonna say if I had to pick a favorite, probably the couple station.
Yeah, I would agree. I'd go that one, and then probably the second one would probably be the least favorite.
Least favorite.
Oh, God.
Okay. Station. Okay, mine this week.
Oh,
Because
yeah,
it's
by the way, did you see that
no.
video of Bill Witt where he was trying to race his wife in like cable management or whatever?
I saw the thumbnail and was not interested.
Well, for a spoiler alert, he won, but it was kind of a dumb thing because they only gave themselves like 15 minutes to do the shit, and like she was barely able to. Well, actually, I think he did a better job, but she technically won it, I think. But it's like it was just stupid because it's like they only did like they had like a 15-minute timer. They only gave themselves so many like zip ties that they could use and stuff. It's like, I see, I would have rather watched the video where they're actually like taking their time and seeing, because I feel like she would have had a better chance then, you know.
She usually does a pretty good job because she builds a lot of shit for the show. He just does the
Oh,
stuff.
really?
Well, like, I mean, she helps.
Yeah, I mean, I guess she seems to know what she's doing because, yeah, she seems like she's pretty involved with the videos a lot.
Right. Now, my theme this week is literally I just scrolled through and found three that I was like, oh, and oh, and oh.
Some Frank stations.
Right. So, this first one. Got some stuff going on.
It's a little bit modest, but it's
Well,
working.
I mean, he's got a nice wood desktop with different kind of drawers. So you don't
Oh, I
see
know why
that.
you picked this one.
Why?
Because of the fact that you can never have too many of something. Of guitars.
I was gonna say guitars, speakers, monitors, what?
You can never. He has too many guitars, Frank. Blah 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 blah.
You speaking English?
Wah 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 wah.
Right. So, but yeah, this guy, the funny thing is he's got all this stuff, right? And it says, yeah,
Yeah.
had to downsize to ITX for that dorm life. And I'm like, this isn't a fucking dorm?
What?
I'm sure if you just back up, you hit a wall. Because
Yeah.
dorms are not big, right?
Right, now they're basically you get like a studio apartment with like two bunk beds in it or something, you know.
But I mean, he's got decent amount of speakers and I don't know why there's a graphics card on the fucking table. Probably what he was upgrading, I guess. I don't know. But I mean, there's enough shit to keep you interested. I could go here. And like,
You would.
yeah, what? So that caught my eye. And then
Got your eye.
the
Oh,
second
shit.
station.
Second station.
Yeah. He's kind of similar in that he's got a couple of good things. Not a whole lot of good things. But, he's got more than most. Chair's not the greatest. But nice speakers. Nice little audio interface there. Decent headphones.
What kind of headphones are those?
I think they're the are they the Cloud 2s? If I had to guess. Scrolling through real quick.
Scrolling. Scroll down.
Yeah, the HyperX Cloud 2, I think. Oh, actually. Okay. Here. Whoop. Of course, that's not. Okay, zoom enhance. Okay, you see these, Ian?
I see these nuts.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think that's what those are. If I had to venture a guess, the yoke, that see the red yoke there,
Yeah.
at the bottom of the headband where it goes onto the ear cups. So, if I had to guess. And he took the fucking microphone off because he's cut. Granted, it's on a Rosewill. I think it's Rosewill.
What do you think about Roseville?
I mean, I have a remote from them. They're okay. I think it's actually it says Redwood. If someone asked them what microphone stand that is, I can't remember what. I didn't read what it said because I didn't care.
Isn't Roseville like the great value brand?
I mean, they're better than, Sanyo or something. which is like parts we bought it from China. Who gives a fuck, brand? Now,
well, I mean, they're like the Newegg's Great Value brand, though. But...
And then, like, also, it looks like he's got a DSLR for a webcam, right? Because I see a big ass.
Yeah, you can do that.
I see a big ass lens there.
Yeah.
So they got some stuff going.
I think that could be, that's like really overkill though, if you're just doing like little thumbnail for your gaming stream, you know?
Well, you know, if you've got one, you know, if you're not doing nothing else with it.
Well, yeah. It'd always be a pain for me though. Like if you do use that same camera a lot, it'd always be a pain like setting it up for your streams and then taking it out every day.
I mean, some people use their phone for their webcam for all their videos, and that'd be a pain in the ass to have to put it in a thing and then take it out to use it.
Yeah.
And all of a sudden get a phone call.
Trust me, I know, because I was doing that with my phone when I, before I even got a webcam on the show, you know?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, you forgot about all that shit. That was a pain in the ass.
I didn't forget, I just don't care. So
I actually had a... Right. I actually had to have a separate like I had to have two Ians on there.
Yeah.
You remember that shit?
Yeah. See, they can't get more Ian. They had two of them, motherfucker.
Yeah.
Now, see, I like this one because the whole thing is murdered out.
Made it out.
Because look, the lampshades are black. The figure on the desk is black. The speakers are black. The monitor is black. The fucking, all the, you know, all the peripherals are always black, so that's not hard to get anyway, but
peripherals.
Like the, you know, they match the shades, the desk appears black. I mean, really, they photographed it in just enough light to where you could tell what the fuck everything is. Because if they had just did the shit where everyone puts RGB and turns off the lights, all you'd see is the screen and a couple RGB strips.
Yeah.
Like, it's all, like, subdued, like, the Cooler Master logo on the CPU cooler, and now it's how it's just the shape of the shield is same way. It's minimalist, you know, and makes it look...
Minimalist weeb.
Yeah. So it makes it look, you know, very presentable and clean, a clean aesthetic. I enjoy this. And, like, the owl is gold, and, like, the... fake plant potters, they're like gold, aren't they?
Yeah.
So, yeah, it, you know, and like the little knick-knack jacks thing on the fucking desk, that's black. Black on black on black, so.
Black on black.
Black mouse pad with another black mouse pad with a black mouse and black keyboard. I mean, it looks good. I think this is a, Alienware monitor, isn't it?
I don't know.
What do you know, Ian? Nah.
I don't know what I know. Don't know.
Oh, what? May I ask where you acquired the lamps from IKEA? Speakers, audio engines. What's that curve monitor? No, OP by Rackman Brand. Toy called.
And when you look for, like, a monitor as far as, like, what brand it is, like, do you just, like, guess by the stand?
No. No. I mean, the stand helps. But a lot of times it's the shape. Because certain ones will have more of a pronounced chin. Or, like, no bezel at all. It can be, like, BenQ basically has no bezel. LG kind of has a bezel all the way around, but more of a chin than anywhere else. In this instance, I was kind of going by the stand, but from this angle, it's kind of hard to tell. That's why I went back to the comments to try to find it. I could not.
Why aren't the Predator ones like the really like it looks like a boomerang for a stand or whatever on the bottom? The Acer Predators.
Yeah, they're pretty. Pretty red here. Hold on a second.
Ugh.
kept hearing a noise. I was trying to figure out where the hell it was coming from.
Alert, alert, alert.
Right. Warning, warning. So, yeah, I really like this one. And, like, the little figurine, the colors kind of match the keyboard slash match the motherboard. So it's, you know, and all the, like, peripherals have a white light, like the clock and the fucking DAC and the speaker itself.
DAC.
And I'm sure the lamp has just a white light bulb. So I'm appreciating it more and more as I see it. And it currently has the highest rating. So I'm going to say this one's my favorite. How about you?
Well, let's go through them again, if we can. I want to be able to... So that's the first one.
Mm-hmm.
That's the second one.
Mm-hmm.
That's the third one. I guess... Yeah, I would agree with you. And then the first one, they'd be in... they would... For me, they slowly get better.
Well, you got to remember, this one doesn't say he's in a dorm. The other dude says he's in a dorm.
Yeah.
So, yeah. Okay. Now we got to keep on rolling because it's after fucking midnight already. So let's
rolling.
Do news. Okay. So,
yeah.
Gamers Nexus explaining AMD's misleading marketing.
Did you see this? I figured this would be a discussion here.
I watched the first half of it, and then I saw where he's bringing out charts and graphs, and I turned it off. I did, actually, I saw the thumbnail, and I didn't watch it because I figured it would be boring. But later, Epos Vox actually commented because they referenced him because he did so much with live streaming and all that.
Yeah, streaming is kind of like his thing. Like, he gets really in-depth about streaming.
Well, it's important because he not only does it, he teaches people how to use streaming tools, so he has to know what the hell it's doing.
Yeah, he's like obsessed with it. But yeah, like I don't know, like I watched the video a little bit, and like I was trying to follow along what he was saying, just because this was kind of like a discussion piece for like you and stuff. Because I mean, we both love AMD. You especially love AMD, and
why me especially?
Well, I mean, like, you like them better than I do, even, I think.
I don't like Intel, let me say that. Yes, they've made quality products, but their business practices leave something to be desired, and everyone says, oh, I don't buy for brand, I buy for quality. Shut the fuck up. You pay a company. you pay a company. So why can't I speak with my wallet and decide not to pay an asshole company?
Yeah.
So go ahead.
But basically, I guess he was saying that, I mean, his whole thing was like that they're already ahead. Why do they need to like try to spruce up some of these figures here or whatever? You know, that's what Steve was saying, I guess. But I guess, like, they were kind of, like, I'm not sure exactly what they were doing. I guess they just tried to, you know, like, sprinkle on, like, make it sound like the streaming performance was a lot better than it actually was, you know? Like, just fluffing it up, kind of, I guess. I don't know.
Well, they were, you know, they were saying how the Intel one was laughable, and it was bad, but not as bad as they reported.
Yeah. And I mean, Intel is guilty of the same thing. So, I mean, it's not like it's just the business, man. It's corporate BS.
But, boy, a lot of people in this one are saying Steve doesn't know what he's talking about.
Yeah, I thought I'd include the Reddit one too, not just his video, like the. Because you, like, a lot of times you post alternative Reddit things on there, you
Right,
know,
because people
discussions.
comment. People comment and discuss, and it's like people who actually watch the videos and have real thoughts and opinions.
Yeah.
Versus just first.
Steve was just basically saying they don't need to do this. They're already basically winning, you know?
Right. You don't, you're already winning. You don't have to, you know, tip the scale, you know, in your favor. You don't have to pat it.
Oh, we're going for the Hail Mary here.
Right. It's, I mean, they say, at least they say they're testing methodology. Like he said, though, they do that so it gives you a feeling like they're being honest, but not really, because they're still kind of, you know, lying a little bit. So
yeah,
they're just better at lying. Intel just flat out lies and says that's the facts. You don't need to know the facts.
Yeah, and I mean, there a lot of people on that Reddit post. I did notice a couple of them where they were nitpicking about like the graininess or noise of their Steve's and them test benchmarking and whatever. I mean, as far as I know, they've done the most comprehensive benchmarking that I've seen on YouTube at all, because like they even have like a power testing meter station or whatever now in their new place. Just for testing power supplies, I mean. So I'm just saying, like, it seems like they know what they're doing. They don't really have a reason to like bullshit people on it, you know, and they try to do it as thoroughly as they can.
Well, I think, I mean, people are giving him shit because he really doesn't know what he's talking about, but it's surprising how many actual tech tubers don't know what the hell they're talking about when it comes to specific things. Like, did you ever watch Bitwit or any of the other guys try to do any networking stuff? Like when
No,
when
but
you
I can imagine.
Oh, whenever like somebody is building a NAS, they always have to have Wendell on fucking speed dial, because he has an idea what the fuck is like. Okay, we're doing something with Linux. Wendell, because
yeah.
That's his stuff. And we know that streaming isn't really Steve's strong suit. Hardware data and numbers and physical limitations of silicon and stuff, that's his bread and butter. So, I mean, like, I don't know. This is the first benchmark of any thing that can be challenged, basically. Like, they don't, I don't remember, I didn't watch the whole end to see, he doesn't have the third, like, the newer Ryzen chip in his possession, does he? Or was he speaking all, like, theoretically, because the Intel chip does this?
I don't know.
I can't remember. Like I said, I turned it off when he started getting into benchmarks, because
yeah.
He reads numbers. And it's like, you know, it's great information to have, but listening to numbers be repeated, you know, you might as well read it, because it's easier to take it that way. If someone just says numbers, it's like someone reading a math problem to you. It's
right.
Fucking boring. No, I don't. No. So
well, what's the description say? Did they say like something like we have some test samples or something?
Explaining AMD's misleading marketing. X264 stream quality and benchmarks. So I don't. I mean,
he's not pretty thorough on his video descriptions.
Yeah. Well, I mean, you got to be a little clickbaity to get the new people to click it.
Yeah.
That's why Linus was doing the goofy faces with a, you won't believe this, because that's how people view it. But then their core fans are like, you're better than that. And Garen's Dixis is like, man, we're not that better. Anyway.
Yeah, well, like, a lot of times, you really need to let the dust settle and let all the shit be out already, because it's like, I understand a lot of YouTubers want to be cutting edge and be the first to review something or whatever. Or, what do you call that word where you're trying to talk and theorize about stuff? What's the word for that? Speculating. They like to do a lot of speculating videos and all that stuff. It's like, just let the shit be out for a little bit, man.
Right.
or like officially out, and it's just speaking for itself, you know.
Sorry, I was sending a message. Anyway, so yeah, when like stuff's about to come out, they're like, "Oh, just wait for the benchmarks. Just wait for the benchmarks," and they just want to be the first to get those benchmarks out. So, anyway, on to the next story, because goddamn 12:30. Anyway,
yeah,
we're speculating on speculated speculation. Next, so. Yes, the Gamers Nexus again.
Yeah.
What's Xbox this was... Scarlet Zen 2? So this is basically their tech update thing, right? Yeah.
Right. There's a he has a section about the. That's I think it's like the third one down there.
E3, Microsoft finally disclosed a few key details about upcoming consoles. PlayStation, 8K gaming.
It says, as expected, Microsoft is using a semi-custom solution from AMD based on Zen 2. No word on core count, but it's presumably an 8-core part like Sony's AMD's Radeon RDNA architecture that is currently powering Navi will also be presented in some form. Microsoft is also using GDDR6 memory and solid-state storage. Microsoft stating the SSD will also double as virtual RAM. 1962 called and it wants its page file back. There's also support for hardware accelerated ray tracing, unlike Sony. Microsoft made no mention of ray traced audio. And then they talked about the 8K shit. But yeah, I mean, like, basically, they're trying to say that they'll be able to use the SSD for page, you know, as RAM or whatever, too, because it's just gotten so fast. SSD storage has. I mean, I've been meaning to look it up because, like, I was trying to look at, like, so, like, you have 3200, say if you have, like, 3200 megahertz RAM or whatever, like, you have, right?
Yeah.
And then you have, like, what are some of the speeds of, like, an NVMe drive or whatever? Is that, like, do you know, like, what your speed is, like, the read or write or whatever? Isn't it, like a 1200 or something? Like, doesn't it have to get up to be that level where it's, like, in the thousands or whatever for it to be the same level of reading and writing randomly like RAM does, I guess?
Well, I only have a SATA M.2 right now.
Right.
I mean,
because I think the SSD that I have is like, it could do like 500. So it's not even 1,000 yet.
Well, the new Zen 2 is going to have a PCIe 4. So I don't know how Scarlett's going to do with that.
Yeah. Well, like, look up what the, look up like a really expensive NVMe stick is on Amazon or some shit, and that should just say like the read and write on there or whatever.
Hold on.
I mean, we could be comparing two different numbers, but I'm assuming that like if your RAM is 3200, then it could do like 3200, you know, like megabytes a second or whatever of random reading and writing
and arithmetic.
Yeah, that's what I said.
Going by the customer reviews, you see actual usage things here. Just
or maybe it would have been better looking on Newegg, because Newegg tends to list just like the raw specs a little bit better.
Evo. Specifications. Samsung max sequential read 3500 Mbps, sequential write 3300 Mbps. Is that what you're trying to find?
Yeah. So I mean, it's in the 3000s also, so I bet you that'd be pretty comparable. I don't know. I have to look up what the actual read and write speed of like a RAM is, like say if you were using it as like a RAM disk or whatever.
Well, hold on now. Hold on there, Scout.
Hold on there, cowboy.
Didn't they just launch the first 4.0 NVMe? I don't know. I can't find out in here. I don't know. Anyway, basically this is a rehashing of E3 shit.
Yeah, I thought he did the page file thing just sounded interesting. So like, I was like, ooh, what's that all about? You know,
what's that about?
What's that all about?
Google is killing YouTube's Hangouts on air this year.
It's on chips. So okay, so well, we could basically skim past that. I mean, we've already talked about it. I mean, it fucking sucks.
Well, you did it in a nutshell. Was there anything you didn't? Like, basically, they summarize it. Live streaming group video calls on YouTube will be a lot more complicated.
Yeah. And they went in to say that Google Hangouts is basically the only all-in-one. The Hangouts on Air is the only all-in-one thing. Because that was what. That's why me and Ben decided to start doing live with the Hangouts, was because it was like the most. He wanted like a really easy thing, you know?
Yeah, streamlined version.
Yeah. And so basically it's your chat and your streaming in one, you know?
Yeah. I mean, you can do Skype, but Skype blows.
Yeah. Most people do like a Discord and then the OBS or what's the other one called?
I don't know.
The other streaming thing.
Oh. Streaming thing.
But OBS is like the most popular one, at least.
Oh, yeah, because it's open source. That's why, like, they have XSplit, which if you buy
XSplit, that's what is it?
Motherboard, it comes with it for 6 months or whatever, or a year, but I've never activated. I have two motherboards that gave me a free code. I'll use my free shit all day long. I'm not getting hooked on something I got paid for.
Yeah.
USB 4.0 will arrive in late 2020. Yeah, you just got used to USB 3.0 and 3.1 and recently 3.2, right? It's been a confusing mess with the renamed denominators, right? But basically, the USB promoter group is finalizing the specifications of the new standard USB 4.0. Great. I mean, 3.0 slash all the way up to 3.2, that's still a C, right?
I think so.
Okay.
Let me see if they have any reading and writing specs with this.
Well, US 2 lane. Okay, USB 4.0 specification. Up to 40 gigabits per second operation over 40 gigabits certified cables.
Yeah. Oh, okay.
Yeah.
That's pretty fast. Yeah.
I mean, as long as it's faster than 2.
Yeah.
Does anything even come with 2.0 anymore? Like, if you see a 2.0 port, you think, okay, this is old.
Right. Well, I mean, most keyboard and mouse and input devices are still 2, aren't they?
Well, I mean, like, you know, computer hardware.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You mean, like, the motherboards and shit?
Yeah, or, like, a case or something.
Yeah, not a whole lot.
Now it's like all threes or like threes and a couple of like the red ones, which are 3.1s or whatever. Like, I don't know.
What I don't understand is a lot of like say like the RGB shit, the reason you need to buy one of those motherboard splitter things is because they, I don't know why they stay on USB 2 for a lot of shit still. You have to get that. Who was it? Was it NZXT or whatever that made like a motherboard
The internal
header
hub.
splitter? Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, next.
Yeah, not
Next.
much else to talk about that shit because it's just the USB.
Right, more USB shit to get confused with.
Yeah,
You tell somebody USB-A and they already get confused. Oh, I heard this. State of Washington finds Comcast violated Consumer Protection Act over. Wow, 445,000 times.
yeah. So I got a couple Uppy Upperton internet articles.
So, without reading this word for word here, what's the gist?
The gist is what I thought. I figured that you've read about it already. This is an
Nah.
article for you. I ain't read that shit.
Your story, motherfucker. Let me read you a story
It
before bedtime, children. Franklin read
was
that shit.
just.
Comcast isn't exactly new to running afoul of lawmakers, but its recent stunt in Washington resulted in a $9.1 million fine, excluding restitution, is being heralded as the largest trial award in a state consumer protection case. The previous record for case of this kind was 4.3 million. Washington State court ruling earlier this week indicted the ISP Comcast violated the Consumer Protection Act some 445,000 times. Okay, while engaging in dubious practice known as slamming. In slamming customers, Comcast was signing up tens of thousands of Washington residents for its service protection plan without their consent. Furthermore, Comcast failed to accurately represent or inform customers of the cost of the SPP. In total, Comcast was charging almost 31,000 customers for the SPP non-consensually, while it misrepresented the cost to 18,600 Washington customers. So,
Hey, Frank,
yeah.
what was that non-consensual practice called again?
Rape.
Slamming.
Yep, that's what they're doing. I mean,
Yeah.
that's what like everything that's like free trial. If you don't cancel, it will be charged automatically by it. That's why people don't want to put their credit
Yeah.
card in for the free trial with the credit card number. No, that's so you can charge me when that trial runs out.
Yeah.
So, Ajit Pai tries to kill San Francisco's attempt to spur broadband competition. What's the dipshit doing now?
What isn't he doing to rape us? To slam us?
San Francisco's Article 52, approved in December 2016, lets internet service providers use the existing wiring inside multi-unit residential and commercial properties, even if the wiring is already used by another ISP that serves the building. San Francisco Board of Supervisors and then Mayor Ed Lee approved it in order to spur the competition in multi-unit buildings where occupants often have only one option for internet service. Is this like where he's like, oh, it's competitive, even if there's only one market?
Yeah.
This is it. He's like, no. No.
Wow.
See, but before we get into your self-cleaning litter box story, I have an internet story that I heard actually on the radio. So
Oh, really?
I had to Google to find anything on the internets about it here. And this is the first story that I pulled up, and it had a cool picture, so I wanted to talk about it. It's because this is for you and me, us local yokels here in Ohio. Ohio. You know what's round in the high in the middle and round at both ends?
What?
Ohio.
Yep.
So go ahead and see if I can make this page dark. There we go. Blow this up a little bit more, I guess. Okay. So Ohio RFI leverages assets to achieve broadband access goals. Huh? What does that mean? The request for information is an early element of innovative Ohio strategy currently under development. The initiative is being led by Lieutenant Governor John Husted with the goal of providing internet access to underserved Ohioans. Ohio Lieutenant Governor John Husted's office announced an RFI today to explore the options of increasing broadband access to residents. For those who don't know what RFI is, myself included. Oh boy. Request for information. Digital infrastructure assessments and strategy. So, anyway. The Ohio Department of Transportation, ODOT, and Innovate Ohio, headed by Husted, will consider opening fiber optic and telecommunications rights of way controlled by the state to broadband providers in exchange for investment in improving access to underserved Ohioans. So basically, the way they, like, as soon as this story came on, I got a fucking phone call and I had to switch it real quick, turn the radio off, answer the phone call, and I come back and it was gone. So I had to wait. Well, luckily, my commute was long enough I could drive it and the story came back up. Because it's one of those ones they go back every hour, they say the little blurb. So, basically, you know how they've been saying rural Ohioans don't have, you know, I mean, just through the whole rest of the country, they don't have good internet in rural parts of America. Technically, where I live is considered rural, I guess. I mean, it's a town still, but anyway, well, he's open to using the infrastructure that currently exists for, like, cell phone towers, fiber, you know, communication wires, or lines that run along the highway that are, you know, already sanctioned for government and ODOT. He's like, yeah, you can use our infrastructure to, you know, pipe in your fucking internet lines. So they're going to take something that is already built in along a highway or whatever and pipe the internet through that. So they don't have to lay some new, you know, cable.
Yeah.
That's A, that's innovative. B, that'll spark some business because, you know, like the companies that were already gonna, you know, want to run fiber can go, wait, we can just use your existing shit. Okay, hold up. I heard that and I go, ooh, you know, and, you know, DeWine says it's all serious and there. Fuck you, DeWine. You're not doing anything. So, I mean, the solicitation will be open for 21 days and is an early step in it. So they're basically wait. This is like, hey, you know, ISPs, do you want us, you know, use our service to provide your internet to customers? And they're waiting for, you know, companies, I guess, to bite. And that's really, I mean, that'd be great. Well, if you can use government infrastructure for, you know, private domestic, you know, web surfing, I mean, why the hell not?
Yeah,
because it's not like the internet has to run alongside actually in the highway and compete with cars. So,
yeah,
I enjoy this, and I look forward to, I mean, because it's going to be a little while. I'm sure the best option for us is going to be SpaceX with their 900,000 satellites running around blocking the sky for the, you know, astronomers. Sorry, but until then, you know, give me some, you know, this is my chance to get some fucking fiber. I'd be very happy. So,
and if that wouldn't cheer you up, maybe this would.
Aw, puppy snuggles.
Yeah.
Aw. Okay. Back to your self-cleaning litter box.
Okay, but before you get into this is these two things that we're going to talk about here. This is definitely for Doug here, and it sucks that he's not on the show tonight, but what are you going to do? So before I talk about that litter box thing, look at what my parents got. That's a self-filling water bowl. And so you fill this jug up with water and it automatically fill it keeps the water level. It doesn't overflow it and it just stays the same water level until the thing runs out.
Yes.
So that's like an automatic thing. Doug would be like, well, that defeats the purpose of having an animal.
Yeah.
And
We had one
then,
of those too, but those design, like, you got the one with the screw off top where you can add water to it. Ours didn't have that. You had to take the water out, and every time you fill the jug up and put it back in, the where the water actually goes is fragile and it would break. I had
yeah.
for my plus, well, I had for my cat, I actually had an electric fountain, so I'd fill up a bottle that would go on the back and it would run through the a filter and come out cleaner. But in your case, dogs, we have two dogs and their water dishes get dirty as soon as I clean them. So even if the water keeps getting topped off, mud and dirt, I imagine, will get in there like really nobody's business.
Right. I mean, they're
Ours,
not
like my
too
cats,
lucky then.
it had an actual charcoal filter in the middle of it.
Oh, really?
But you know, it was electric, so water was actually passing through it. It had a pump and everything. So.
Well, it just like the other thing though, the litter box is like a self-emptying thing where it like separates like the poop from the litter and stuff, and then you can dispose of that. So,
I'm sure he has a problem with the clumping cat litter. Oh, they gotta, you know, clump the turds and the, you know, and the urine so it's all, they can just scoop it out. Ugh.
yeah, like I don't know. I mean, I guess I could kind of. I was trying to understand his argument. I guess the whole argument is like, you know, that you're, you get more of a connection when you do that type of thing, but
He thinks the owners are
I
being
don't
lazy,
know.
is what it is.
Yeah, he thinks the owners. Oh, sorry, Nico. Oh, damn, I stepped on his paw by accident. I'm sorry.
Now
Yeah.
this litter box I've actually seen, it's like a rock tumbler for cat poop.
Yeah.
They poop in it and then it spins around and it basically it's like a scooper, but the whole thing is one big scoop that shakes the poop and then the clumps in the poop just fall to the bottom and then you scoop it out.
Yeah.
Which, why would anyone want to sift through poop?
Right. I mean, like I was saying on the show, like that. I mean that type of stuff, like sure it might make you more lazy, but I mean it's like that type of stuff is just it's like you got to get through that stuff to get to the part that means that's not, that stuff isn't meaningful. It's
Right,
the connection that you have with the animal, you know?
you just have your cat looking at you going, yeah, scoop up my turds.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, scoop that shit. So.
I mean it's not like I would say, oh yeah, if you had a robot to walk your dog for you. I'm not saying like that's just to walk around and have fun in the park and play catch. I mean, I wouldn't do that type of stuff. Like they even have things where you can talk to a dog through like a speaker and it'll shoot out like a treat or whatever. I mean,
This
I'm
like,
not sure if I would get something like that, but like
if you're away from your house and your dog's not in a crate, that would be, you know.
yeah.
I can imagine like Back to the Future, how like when Marty it gets away from the DeLorean and old Biff steals the DeLorean. That's because he sees a dog being walked by a robot, and he goes, "What the hell? You still there?"
Yeah, I'm still
Okay,
here.
I just saw your picture. But this is a Doug story. He's mad because people, you know, do have to do things and don't want to rough it. Unless it's him. So, Borderlands 3 interview, Insanity Rules. So,
Yeah.
what's doing here?
I'm not too I don't know too much about this, but I do know, I guess, like the there's like a he was the one guy that's like the head guy that was doing an interview from the Borderlands, like developers or whatever. I guess he was there was like a lot of drama or something in the interview, and like I don't know too much about it, I'm sorry. I guess there's like some abuse going on or something too in the company. Like they were really grilling them too, I guess, you know.
Second. Was refilling my beverage. So, yeah, I mean, like, I know the guy who did the voice of Claptrap, he, like, didn't do it for the newest game because he said some executive, like, threatened him or whatever, assaulted him.
Right.
So there's a whole bunch of crap going on. I mean, it's,
A lot of these, a lot of stuff with developers now with video games and shit, a lot of it's getting to be like, Hollywood and shit, you know, like
I mean,
Hollywood actors.
well, it's like, just like the Me
I
Too
don't.
movement. Everything bad's going to come out and everyone's going to know dirt about everything. Nothing can stay hidden
Yeah.
in this day and age.
Right.
And as well it should, if actual abuse or, anything is going on, sexual, physical, mental, we look at stuff like this, just like the, just like what is it, the people who watched anime back in the day said, "Oh man, that looks like my dream job," and then they found out, "Oh no, they work you to death." "Oh, this is my
Yeah.
dream job." "Oh no, they're horrible, horrible people." I mean, and I'm gonna sound cliche. Imagine people that dream about, scenarios where you're violent and lots of explosions. They are kind of fucked up, but yes, they're fucked up people. Not because they play video games, not because they make video games. They make video games and they're fucked up.
Yeah, like I
Different.
always thought, like how when people try to come up with like really disturbing like demons and creatures and like fucked up storylines, like what kind of people do they have to get to think about that shit, you know?
Very damaged people. How
Yeah, it's
EA.
like that.
Oh, go
It's
ahead.
like that kid. You ever have you seen any trailers or whatever for that? I think it's called Brightburn or whatever, that movie.
No.
It's basically like he's like an evil Superman or something, and you could see all of his it's a kid and he's getting all these superpowers and stuff, but he's like in his like drawings and stuff, they're all like demons and shit, you know. Come on, Nico.
I
Yeah.
mean, if you think about it, if the real Superman showed up, oh yeah, he's an alien. No, he's a demon. Burn him. And then, oh, nope, never mind. He can't burn.
Yeah.
How EA talks about loot boxes depends on who's listening.
So I guess Yay was lying about loot boxes again or something.
Oh boy. I mean, what did they think? I mean, EA isn't all about that moolah, right?
Right. Let me see what it says. EA has been on the ropes before countless times for angering its fans. In 2011, it was the ending of Mass Effect 3. 2 years later, the company took the long-running and beloved Sin City franchise and made that year's version into a game that required an internet connection to play. Servers were slammed and people couldn't play the game's single-player mode as a result. It took months to sort problems out, and then EA shattered the studio 2 years later. Or shuttered the studio. The firm has been named worst company in America by fans polled by the consumerist multiple times, beating out predatory mortgage lenders and healthcare companies. And each time it's happened, EA has responded by digging its heels in and stubbornly saying it's done nothing wrong on investors' calls and to the press before admitting the exact opposite months later in a public forum like its annual E3 keynote or during a game reveal. A few weeks ago, the cycle started anew. The Daily Show's Trevor Noah hosted the Battlefield 5 debut event and asked the developers present how progression would work during the streamed question and answer session. The team gleefully told Noah that there wouldn't be any loot boxes or premium passes for additional maps and modes. They repeated that yesterday on stage before announcing that after being inundated with requests for by fans, Battlefield 5 will include a Battle Royale mode. The audience applauded. But when Battlefield 2's design director, Dennis Bronvald, came out later, he recapped the controversy before offering a mea culpa and detailing a fan-centric roadmap for additional expansions to the game's multiplayer suite. "We launched our game last November, and clearly we didn't get it right," Bronvald said. "Instead of coming out of the gate sprinting like we really wanted to, we had to take a step back and make sure that we were delivering the game that our players really wanted. Specifically, DICE changed the progression system so that it wouldn't take this estimated 40 hours to unlock Darth Vader as a hero character in the game, and eventually that the in-game loot boxes would only contain cosmetic items, not items that affected gameplay." You never pause for applause. Never pause for applause. And it took a full 2 minutes before the audience responded to anything he was saying, only breaking silence when Brainball announced the forthcoming add-on pack from the Clone Wars, the popular Star Wars TV show. This is a long article, man.
Yeah, let's just look at my picture here, and this sums it up. So we got the accessory for PS4, Xbox One, Steam, and then EA is just put your credit card in, motherfucker.
Yeah.
So, yeah, here's that.
Together we will make this game the greatest game that we can possibly build.
Nah, ain't gonna do that. This next.
And this 10th one, I just included this and went in here because I'm OCD and I had 9 articles and I figured I'd make it 10.
Gears 5 won't have a season pass and DLC maps will be free. Well, that's good.
Yeah, the title says it all.
Oh, man, why even have to read anything?
Yeah.
Might as well just been a headline with a picture.
Right.
Is that your last story?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah.
Now, I've got a few articles. This is kind of gamery, but kind of tech. I'm just going to throw stuff up real quick and not really expand upon it. This SSD turns gold when it heats up to cheer on gamers. What?
Do what?
Imagine if AMD or Intel built a processor that could talk, and as the temps ramped up at its thermal limit, it offered words to encouragement. Something like, "Hell yeah, now you're cooking with Crisco. Keep going." That would be silly, right? A Pacer said, "Hold my beer," and built a solid-state drive that communicates through general messages, just not verbally.
Hold my beer.
The AS2280P2 Pro Panther SSD is equipped with battle armor or a color-changing heatsink that reacts to heat. That's actually an interesting and potentially useful idea, except instead of going from blue to red to let you know that throttling might occur, it changes from orange to a dazzling golden color when temperatures rise, cheering on gamers even more.
Gamers.
In other words, hell yeah, now you're cooking with Crisco. Keep going, only that's the wrong message. Yeah, it's kind of dumb. Now, I'm surprised you have this because it's a Doug story.
Is that going to piss him off too?
Probably. Mad Max, no enthusiasm for the Mac Pro. I asked Ben what he thought about the fucking thing because, like, basically, the Mac Pro is a. I've seen one video where the guy gave it a positive thing, but even he had to say, it's not for most people. No. It's, you know, no compromises, high-end machine that if you want to pay for it, it'll do everything you want. And I'm like, or you could just get a better value and build it your fucking self. So, I don't understand what's going on there.
Yeah, what is going on with Ben? I haven't heard from him in a while. Is he exchanging some maple fluids?
He's back from Canada.
Oh, okay.
But,
AMD
EPYC 7452 7-nanometer Rome CPU with 32 cores and 64 threads benchmark spotted dominating position against Intel Xeon much faster than EPYC Naples. So basically, the new 7-nanometer EPYC is probably going to destroy Intel, which, I mean, that's what Ryzen is doing. So. They've been trying to, you know, like I said, they're trying to get into the server market, which they're doing, but they just got to be able to completely do it. And, you know, I'm rooting for the guys. Everyone's like, oh, you're rooting for them because you feel like you're rooting for an under. No, I just like them better. So, anyway.
Yeah. I mean, they're like all the hotness right now, man.
By the way, Cyberpunk 2077 won't let you drive flying cars. Where we're going, we still need roads. I saw this article literally like right after we did the show last week, and I was like, well, why even fucking do it? I mean, it is kind of shitty. Like, you're in the future, but cars don't fly yet. And
I guess they were trying to be realistic because it's like, I mean, even if it's like 50 years from now, it's still probably just going to be the same shit, just better, you know?
I mean, every sci-fi thing, though, like, this is a made-up sci-fi. Like, this is a, what do they call that, retrofuturism, where it's what it would look like in the future back then, but, like, we know it's not going to look like that. I don't know, like...
Well, did we talk about our thoughts about the Keanu Reeves thing?
I think we did, but you go ahead. Tell me what you think.
Oh, I mean, I think it's pretty cool. I don't know if you've had any like discussions on it or thoughts about it, but
no,
I mean,
I like Keanu.
It looks pretty cool.
I want the fucking game to come out already.
Is it like a Neo Tokyo type of thing?
I mean, the looks and like, there's been like some YouTube. Reviewers I follow have gone to like things where they could watch the like playthrough of the game, but like they can't record anything, so they have to come back and talk about it. Like that guy Juicehead, who does a bunch of Fallout videos, he went to an event where he saw it and was talking about it a bit.
Well, is it a series or is that like the first Cyberpunk game?
No, it's. Not the first Cyberpunk game. It's just the newest, like, you know, it's like, you know, the latest and greatest game. Because there's Cyberpunk games now, but a lot of them are, like, you know, just the subject matter of Cyberpunk or, like, it's, you know.
Well, like, what's the storyline of the whole series in general?
It's kind of like a little bit like you in the city you're at, there's a lot of crime and everything, and you've got to deal with the gangs and like You gotta either take down the boss of the gang or join up, etc., etc.
Etc.
And the gangs are like they can be modified with like bionic implants or whatever. So like Biff from Back to the or Griff from Back to the Future, if you remember Biff's grandson.
Yeah.
So you got that kind of shit going. Like I said, YouTubers talk about it, but it's hyped up now because little has been revealed. A trailer came out, but that was a trailer that's not production. It's like anyone can make a video where it looks cool, but to actually make that thing look cool, what you play is a different feel altogether.
Well, it looked pretty realistic. I mean, some people are saying it looked like they were watching a movie.
Well, I mean, yeah, but until you can get a playable demo, then that's when you can talk. Because,
Yeah.
No Man's Sky, everyone had a boner for it, and then they're like, eh.
Well, was there supposed to be any RTX shit on there?
I have no fucking idea.
No.
By the way, I almost forgot. There was
I'd
I don't.
imagine RTX would be pretty important for like a Neo Tokyo thing with all the puddles and shit.
Yeah, probably. Let me, Sure.
Uh-oh.
Filter. I saw a battle station where a guy made it. Here we go. He made a Cyberpunk 2077 themed. Why is it not letting me find it? He made a Cyberpunk 2077 themed battle station, but it was sad because the actual guts of the system were like low spec.
Oh, disappoint.
Yeah, like, hold on. Oh, here we go. This gotta be it. No. Oh, hold on, let me just do an image search because I remember what the main image looked like.
Let me do a reverse image lookup here and then
Well, before I could search just the subreddit. Anyway, yeah, it was like a FX processor, like a 960.
You don't say.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I can't find it. It was funny because the guy put in all this work and like I shared it with on somewhere and they're like, "Oh yeah, no. Why would you do that? Why would you waste your time?" Because like they're like it won't play the it won't be able to play the game, and I'm like, "Oh, the fuck, won't be able to play the trailer." I don't.
Now, nah, man, your NAS could still play some shit, man.
Huh? Well, yeah, but I mean, I've got a 380. This has like a. I mean, you could play games, but not the. I think the minimum specs for this thing are like, I don't know. They're higher end, basically.
Oh, okay.
The game's not even out yet, so.
You said you had like a 960 or something?
I don't think. I think it might have been like even a 920.
Huh.
God damn it.
He was using an AGB card.
Oh, here we go. Damn it, I keep finding like new stuff. But I don't want. This is like just recent. Anyway, go ahead and close the search out. Anyway. Okay, so that's that. Oh, by the way. So Fallout 76's Battle Royale preview is going to continue indefinitely, which everyone's like, yeah, they probably planned that already. Because, like, you know, it's like, oh, you know, for a week you can play it. Oh, no, never mind. You just keep on playing it. And
keep
it's
on trucking.
Right. They're like, oh, wait, people are, you know, going to do it? Shit. It's apparently the most popular mode. I mean, which is kind of funny because it had a survival mode, but I guess that, you know, that isn't as popular as the Battle Royale mode. Kids love them some Battle Royale. I mean, I don't know why.
I don't know, man.
Never got into it. Even Juice said, the guy, I watched his, he did a playthrough, and then later he commented about it. He's like, you know, he's like, I'm not into Battle Royales. He's like, but he's like, I left to go to E3 after this happened. Because he like, Bethesda announced it before E3. And he watched them announce it, and then he played it. He says, I stopped playing to go to E3. And he's like, I actually miss it. And he didn't miss the actual, just the game. Because he said he was not enjoying playing it, but he has to for the channel.
Yeah.
But also, for this week, in the Atom shop for free, you can get a pride flag as your character icon.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Huh. I saw this and I'm like, you know, I'm not gay, but I'm supportive, so I went ahead and got it.
Right.
Because you don't have to be your character. You can. But you don't have to.
Yeah.
It's free.
Well, freemium is nice.
Now,
I was going to ask, like, in general with the Fallout games, like, does your character not speak? He's like, you know, like a mute type of character.
Who, me, or like in general with every
game? In general with most of the Fallout games.
In 4, the main protagonist was fully voiced. And people didn't like that because for your dialogue options, instead of actually showing the entirety of what your answer was going to be, you would have a 4 option wheel that say sarcastic, angry, or whatever, and then you would press it and you would then see your answer.
Oh, okay.
In 76, there are more. The dialogue options, like when they say something to you, you can reply, like, it'll be either be like a speech check or like with your special perks. So, like, your charisma for your speech or for like your intelligence. You know, if your charisma, like, they can try to make you do something and you can try to talk them out of it, and that could work or not. So, it's, you know, you're not voiced. I think it's because they don't want to bother with a male and female voice. Especially
if you got to do a Hispanic and then a black, and do every kind of possibility.
Well, I think originally, like, their whole intention to, you know, have people talking to each other, they, you know, you couldn't mute your mic at first. And
is it?
So I figured all we gotta do is make some characters run around, give you a couple of emotes, and people will be able to communicate. And then now you got NPCs, so you're gonna have dialogue options. I assume the next like actual chapter name, because this is just a fork of 4. You know, what if we made 4? You know, online. Well,
right.
5 is probably going to be single player again with, you know, probably fully voiced, which really I don't mind because the voice actors in 4 were good because they had male and female. Because in 4, you're a married couple, and then if you're playing as a man, the wife is murdered, and if you're playing as a woman, the husband is murdered, and the protagonist is voiced.
If they do make a 5th game, where do you go from there? Is it going to be more of a prequel thing, or are they going to go more in the future, in like a different time period that they didn't cover, or
wherever? Because
do they kind of leave it open for that?
Well, see, the thing is, the way they do it now, this game actually, the current game, 76, takes place the earliest in the universe. If you follow the timeline. Okay.
Yeah, what's the timeline like for us? It was a graph.
If you go by the time in the games, 4, the game before this one, the character was in suspended animation, so you wake up 210 years later.
Okay.
And in Fallout 1, after it's 80 years after the war because you were in the vault and you were born there, so you had no idea of what the outside world was like. And then in Fallout 2, it was 80 years after that, a whole generation of the people after your character. And I don't know how far apart 3 and 4, or 3 and New Vegas were. And,
That was New Vegas, that was a separate game, that wasn't just like an add-on?
No, it was its own game. It was the one that wasn't made by Bethesda or Black Isle Studio, Interplay or whatever. See, Bethesda acquired the rights in Fallout 3, and they made a game then. And then after they made 3, they let Obsidian make it. So they made New Vegas, and then Bethesda made 4, and then Bethesda made 76 again. And they're probably not going to stop making them because, like they said, it, you know, one of the presentations was the most popular game ever. So. But anyway, my article is the hardest thing you can do in a Fallout game is unexpected. It's easy as pie, or not. I knew this because I've seen YouTube videos on the subject. In the at least 4, there is a porta diner, which is, in the future, everything's automated and there's robots running around. And, like, you have your own personal robots, etc. And they've got a little, that's food. And in the future, well, in their, alternate future, there are so many preservatives and shit in the food, it doesn't go bad. Like, this porta diner here, it activates as a grabber claw game, like a mini game within Fallout, where you attempt to grab a perfectly preserved piece of pie. But when you're trying to get this perfectly preserved piece of pie, your companion you'll have with you, they have dialogue, and they'll say something like, "I would need it. Anything that would keep a 200-year-old pie preserved probably isn't worth eating."
It's basically a plastic chemical pie.
Yeah. Well, in the beginning of 4, you actually start out before the war, and then you freeze, and you come out 200 years later. Well, when he's, when you're walking around pre-war, you go into the closet and you're like, all this food that expires, never. That's why you still run into food. Like, that's a loophole they had to write into the game, because how are you going to, survive in the future, if everything's blown up and irradiated? Well, you can, there's food, it's preserved. Sometimes it'll have some radiation.
But, yeah.
So
if they decided to do like a reboot type of thing, would you ever be into that?
A reboot of what?
Of Fallout, like, they're like, no, this shit happened before this game.
What, like a prequel?
No, they're like that, you know, like a reboot, like just like how a movie does it, you know, where they're like this other shit that's it didn't happen. This is what really happened. You know?
There's already like before Bethesda came out with Fallout 3, Interplay was actually going through some legal trouble, so they let another company or two make a version of the game. So there's a shitty game that bears the name Fallout on it. I think it's Fallout Brotherhood of Steel for the Xbox and PlayStation. And it just has Fallout in the name only. The actual characters, plot, and everything is just some generic shit that was slapped together. And Bethesda acts like that didn't exist. Whereas the newer games follow the older ones. Like, they make sure everything's canon. Like, the sound effects, the even some of the models of, like, the weapons, etc., are very similar to the original. The newest game, though, people are mad that they took liberties with reasoning of why certain, like, villains would be in, you know, within this area, why certain factions would be where they are. They don't think they would match up in the timeline. And they say, well, because this and this. So, yeah. But anyway, the whole point of this article, god damn it, let me get through my story, is this Grabber Claw game is very fucking hard. And the guys I've seen on YouTube, at least, pump themselves full of chems, which, you know, drugs. They don't want to say the word drug. Chems that increase your luck, because you can ramp up your luck. They build your character. You put all your specs into luck, and then you take drugs that make your luck higher. And even then, you... like, it's a dice roll. You might or might not get the piece of preserved pie. Like, this guy does the, you know, the chance. Here's actually the formula. And, yeah, even if you have your luck at 10. The pie. Your odds increase the more you try, but the most normal people aren't going to sit there and try for very long.
It's pie.
How good can it be? That answer is, it gives you an extra 30 hit points for no variation, which isn't bad, but still. So, yeah.
It's my pie.
No, Kenny. And I have one last story, which is, I don't know what the fuck, because just check it out. Check this shit out. Hold up. Russia mocks SpaceX by sending a toy car into space. SpaceX CEO Elon Musk's ambitious space move in February 2018 made headlines in after a private American aerospace company launched a cherry red Tesla car roaster into space on a rocket to Mars. Now a team of Russian scientists is making a mockery of Musk by sending a red toy car into space last week. While SpaceX launched a full-size car into orbit with a dummy Starman behind the vehicle's wheel, Russia's Tomsk State University researchers sent a toy car that's a replica of Red Zhuguli, owned by the country's Roscosmos Space Agency head Dmitry Rogozin, who is not trash-talking Musk. In a YouTube video shared by the team on Tuesday, the toy replica could be seen on a trip to the stratosphere with a cutout of a smiling Rogozin placed in the driver's seat. And here it is.
Was this in your What the Fuck articles?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
I'm just going to leave it at that. So, that's my last story, sir.
What made you decide to choose this? Just like, it was...
I enjoy the whole concept of SpaceX. I enjoy Elon Musk, and then, you know, the Russians got a shit all over everything. So, that's that. Anyway.
Right.
Well, thank you for coming on, sir. It's been fun.
It's been fun. Don't let the door hit you, right?
It's been fun. It's been real. I don't know if it's been real fun.
Yeah,
I have to let the dogs out so they don't shit the bed.
you
But anyway, thanks for coming on. You have a good weekend there, Haas, and
guys, if let me guess, if you have an imaginary stream, you'll let me on it.
maybe, probably not.
Maybe. Probably not.
Yeah.
What's your computer overlord there say?
I mean, I'm still on, aren't
Yeah. What is the situation with all that? We got any more updates on that?
I? I turned it on and it runs. I just haven't. I haven't. I didn't. I didn't overclock my RAM to the rated spec. That's the only thing because I did that before and it wouldn't boot. And then when I reinstalled the BIOS last time, I just said fuck it and left it at whatever default settings and just told it to ignore that the CPU fan speed wasn't reporting because I have six fans. It's not going to tell the RPMs of all of them. So.
Yeah. Well, how's your gameplay? Because that was one of the things last week you were saying, like your playing Fallout was pretty choppy or whatever.
Oh, it was the thing was freezing. It was like taking forever. It was so laggy. Like if I move the wheel like this, like if I move the mouse around the screen like this, I'd
Yeah.
see this. And then it would just totally freeze. And I'm like, well, fuck this. Or like I open it and the like before the actual gameplay, there's like a little like the theme for the credits and all that, like the company name and all that. Nothing. You'd hear it, but you couldn't see it. I don't know what the hell was going on, but
It's better now that you turned it on.
I mean, now that I can start it up and actually use it, yeah, I've gamed all night the other night, so I'm
Now,
just
I was thinking, I think it could be your motherboard could be kind of flaky.
nah. Nah. I think it might just be my chip, because like it's
Oh, you
at a
mean your
low.
processor?
Yeah, it's. It's it, like the frequency, it's jumping around. It's at 2200 right now. It was at like 1950. That's lower than I was at earlier. Like when it was completely freezing, I had it at 4 gigahertz, 4.0, and it stayed locked at 4.0. Now it's at 3900. So, it can jump up and down on its own. That's cool. I'm just gonna leave where it's at. I'm fine. I don't give a shit.
Who gives a shit?
Right? I don't care. As long as I can fucking play my damn game.
If you play your damn game once a week there or whatever.
Yeah, that's all I got time for. So, bye.
Peace.
Thanks for coming on, everyone. I gotta go let the doggies out. Have a good night.
You too.
Bibs.
Boobs.